broadcasting live from beautiful Midtown Manhattan. We're on a clear night. You can almost see a simple everyday billionaire go on to become mayor of New York. It's the Ron and Fez Show. And I'm your announcer, Hodge from Ironworks. And now let's introduce your hosts, the guys who are wondering, since Mike Bloomberg isn't going to accept his mayor's salary, can they have it? Here they are, Rod Bennington, Fez Watley, Radio's Dark Horses.
Buddy, it's the Ron and Fez Show.
Buddy,
you lucky bastards. What a program tonight.
It's almost 10 after, not everything's done yet.
Late meetings. Very late meetings today. Not more meetings. The Ron and Fez Show is beginning. I'm Ron. And if my partner was a woman, well, then I'd have the funniest wife in the world. It's Fez Watley.
Sweet talker Betty Crocker, hiya.
I wouldn't need anything else, Fezzy. Also, sitting
No one will ever love you like I do, Ron.
Sitting in with us tonight is going to be Joe Poo.
Hello.
Joe.
What?
See, now, you know, the thing is, once we get that voice down, who needs him?
Sure.
I'll be Joe Poo.
I'm useless anyway.
That's true.
That's sad but true.
It was nice to meet you in the hall. I just had a chance to meet a couple screaming Opie and Anthony guests.
Yes, they were. They seem like delightful young ladies.
Where are they? I'm like, hey, I'm a whole different show.
If I had known I was coming up here for this ass.
I had to say, hey, lady, what happened to you has nothing to do with me. I was eating a sandwich.
Off.
I was eating a sandwich. Tonight, Fuzzy, we're going to celebrate Crazy Claire's... birthday.
Nice.
Crazy Claire, supposedly on her way in. She's a little late already. But the insane do not keep good time. We know that.
Yes, we've learned that by now. Crazy Claire, of course, been in the nut hut on more than one occasion.
Right.
Known in the past, like to take the knife to herself.
Although she says she's dealt with that pretty good.
Right, yeah.
She's worked that out. But now she just likes to use her knife to cut the clothes off of others.
That's her eroticism. That's what she enjoys from her knife play now.
Now, the other thing Crazy Claire tells us that she's been looking for is a woman.
Hmm?
She wants a gal, Fezzy, somebody she can be close to.
Okay. Well, that should be easy enough.
We got Claire what I say is the perfect birthday present. A beautiful little redhead. It's Liz. Say hi, Liz.
Hi.
Hi, Liz.
Now,
welcome to the show.
Here's the situation. People say, you know, they always go up and say, oh, I'm hot. And you go, okay, sure you are.
Uh-huh.
Please come in and let us see you before we ever fall for that bit again. Liz is so hot and fuzzy that I can't stand it. Now, you've seen the pictures of Claire?
Yeah, she's gorgeous.
And are you more into, would you say you're more into women or you're kind of on the bi side?
I'm definitely more into women.
Really?
Yes. Sorry, Ron.
No, that's okay. You couldn't make me happier. Your choices made me happy. As long as you and Claire are happy tonight, then I will be happy.
Good.
So you also, look at the Macedonian. Peaks in here every time we got a woman.
You know, the Macedonian is just gigantic.
Right.
And there's no hiding you when you try
right.
to sneak, Robert.
I'm sorry, I can't help it. I mean, you know...
You never have anything to do with us until we get a beautiful woman, then you're down.
Lately,
hey, you need any
like
promos.
Every day, you know
yeah.
what I mean?
Let me know if you need anything from promotions.
Well, I always,
I'm here for you.
I'm always here for you. You know,
right.
Listen, I offered to break the guy's legs last week for you, you know? I mean...
And I appreciate
don't
the offer.
Don't forget that, you know?
Yeah. Well, I'll let you know if we need Liz's legs broken, but so far,
no,
so
no,
good.
No, I won't break her legs at all.
Thank you, I appreciate
well,
that.
You know, he walks around here with that big gold chain, and for a long time, I didn't know what that pendant was.
Yeah.
It's a map of Macedonia.
Is that what it is?
And it's just huge, hanging off the end of a gold chain.
I thought it was one of the original gold medals. When they actually had BC written on them.
From the first Olympics.
All right, so as a little surprise for Crazy Claire, Liz said you would let her cut your clothes off tonight.
Absolutely.
Now, let me ask you this. Have you ever been into the cutting before?
Nope, never.
Now, does it scare you a little bit that the woman that you're a little interested in is insane?
I find it very interesting.
Me too.
Yeah.
Yeah, because you've never met Crazy Claire.
Nope. Right.
And yet you're willing to hand her the knife knowing she's certifiable.
Yes.
Wow, that's exciting, Fez.
That's good stuff.
Now, also, Joe Poo said it was something that would excite him to be cut and have his skin cut and his clothes cut off, he said.
Oh, nice. Yeah, so Joe's absolutely getting his clothes cut off tonight.
It's a beautiful thing.
Now, if you were in the guys, would you like Joe Poo?
Yeah, he's cute.
Yeah, he's adorable.
Thank you.
You're welcome. He's much cuter than he sounds. I can't get that across to the listeners.
Sometimes I look over at Joe and I think, if Fez and I ever had a stillborn baby, it would be Joe Poo.
Right, that didn't live for very long.
Right.
Uh-huh.
A blue baby.
Sure, born blue.
I'm flattered.
Or if I had taken thalidomide through the pregnancy. Yeah.
And he had flipper arms.
Uh-huh. Was a little Merc baby. Yeah, that would be him.
Mama. It's me, Baby Poo.
And, like, maybe if during my 8th month you got mad at me and threw me down a flight of stairs, that would be him.
Hey, Liz, let me ask you this. How many women do you think you've been with so far in your life?
I haven't been with many. I've been in 2 long-term relationships.
Really?
Yeah, so.
How about guys? I saw you looked a little turned off.
I haven't really been in a relationship with, I've done stuff with guys, but.
Have you went all the way with guys?
Yes.
And you don't like that at all?
It's not. It's all right, but yeah. Being with
What's
a girl is much
better. What's not to like, Liz?
Fezzy, please. When you look at her,
I'm trying to interview a guest.
When you look at Liz, is it like Earth 2 Fez? You're polar opposite.
I would have red hair on Earth 2.
You're like Jack Spratt and his lovely wife, Fezzy. Hey,
I can eat no fat.
Al, can I get a glass of water? Thanks, buddy. Now, do we hear from Claire? Does she got a cell phone?
She doesn't have a cell phone, but I've checked all the ways that she's been messaging me, and she hasn't messaged back.
One of those was smoke signals, so he's been checking the skies.
I just, I hope she hasn't had an episode. Or I might have to cut Liz's clothes off.
Somebody's going to have to.
All right, thank you for the water. Don't get me anthrax water out of there, Joe. No, I don't drink fountain water.
Joe, you're so disgusting. We have a refrigerator full of O2Go.
Right.
And you're grabbing.
He was hacking. I thought he needed some right away.
You're getting Mountain Fresh faucet water.
I should have brought that up during the meeting.
I'll take that down. No tap water.
Quit taking things down.
Yeah, don't write down things.
I'm in serious mode.
Joe, Friday night we are actually giving the show to Joe. He has a big promotional idea.
That's right. Of course, we have JetBlue airline tickets to give away. JetBlue Airways, pair of round-trip tickets. We're going to have another pair. We have a pair tonight. We have another pair Friday. Of course, Joe Poo, you have an idea to give away the pair on Friday night show?
Yeah. How does this sound? How much can you spew for JetBlue? And what we'll do is we'll have some contestants up here.
Right.
And they'll drink a lot of alcohol in a short period of time. And whoever pukes the most at the end of the show, we will save it in buckets and weigh it.
We're going to weigh buckets of spew.
Yeah, on a meat scale.
I don't think many people throw up when they drink. I think children do.
Right?
But I don't think adults throw up when they drink.
No, that's a tradition in my drinking escapades.
Is that right?
Oh, I throw up every time.
Every time you're drinking, you throw up.
Yeah, I have to cleanse the body.
That's a waste of alcohol.
No, because when I lay down, it feels like I have a gallon of water just swaying back and forth.
Ew. I hung out with Joe Poo last Friday after the show. He ended up puking.
Yeah, purged in Hoboken.
Puking on the platform of the PAT train. Not even on the tracks, Liz. Just right there on the platform.
That's nice.
In front of you, Fez? In front of everybody?
Yeah, right there.
Now,
no shame.
Happens to the best of us.
You
throw up a lot, though? She's doing it now. She's so cute.
Even when she's puking.
I wish I was a little lesbian girl and could just have a long relationship with her. Isn't that a song by somebody? I wish I was a little lesbian girl. All right, so your chance to win JetBlue tickets Friday night. Give us a call now if you throw up a lot and want to join this contest. We'll just take a couple people, Fez.
Right.
877-692-1027. Now, do you only get one puke?
No, as much puke in a set period of time.
Wow, you really seem to have thought this out.
Yeah, the most puke at the end of the hour or 2 hours wins the contest.
So we have to stand here around buckets of puke for 2 hours?
Yeah, because I got to weigh it on the fish scale.
Now it's a fish scale.
This is
going to
be the worst thing ever.
And it seems like it's way too many props needed.
No, it's
you know, I might throw up if I see a fish scale.
Blech.
I know, Lisa Croft tells me that she throws up a lot when she drinks.
Really? Pantera's girlfriend.
But why, Fez?
I don't know.
Doesn't that defeat the whole thing? Aren't you supposed to drink to feel better?
Yeah, but then
not
you drink...
Not to pick up flu-like symptoms?
You drink too much, and then you spew.
How much is too much for you? A bottle?
It just seems like a big waste of money to go out and buy shots and drink all night and then puke them up.
It's going to come out the other hole anyway.
All right. Here's one of the things that I worry about. I think once they start puking, they should have to stop drinking because I don't want somebody acting like they're drinking a beer and then puking into the fish scale.
Yeah, just spitting it back out.
Right, so that doesn't work.
There'll be a bucket.
I know, but what I'm saying is suppose they're spitting right into the bucket their beer.
I'll take care of that.
No, you're not going to take care of it. We have to have actual rules.
Yeah, if people are drunk enough to puke, they're going to be out of control and we need to keep it as simple as possible.
I'm taking notes down now.
And also, this thing should be named after you, so Fez and I are distanced. And do it on a different show.
Right.
What show?
Joe Poo's Bucket of Spew.
I don't have my own show.
How about Sid Rosenberg's sports wrap-up? Whatever Sidney's calling a show now.
That'd be good. Or even take it on TV. New York One, something.
All right, here's Danny. Danny, you're on Ron and Fez. How you doing?
Hey, Danny.
Yeah, listen, I got a problem with Joe's idea.
Me too.
Because it's all it's going to boil down to is whoever eats the most before they start the contest is going to win. I mean, if I eat 5 hamburgers and then puke, I'm going to have 5 hamburgers in that bucket as opposed to the guy who comes in without eating.
So well, why not eat more?
Yeah, go for it.
Who's stopping you from eating 8 hamburgers?
Eat lead pencils.
Well, I'm saying, you know, if it's about drinking, it's actually about drinking.
Isn't it more about puking? Because in any normal contest, if you puke, you're a non.
You can't just eat a whole lot and stick your finger down your throat?
Yeah, whatever. You just gotta puke a lot. That's the name of the game. You puke in the bucket and I weigh it. Whoever has the most puke wins.
Okay, but to be devil's advocate, if you're eating, like, let's say the 5 hamburgers, like Danny said, and then you have to puke to win, what's the point of drinking anyway?
That's what I'm saying.
You just keep drinking more and more.
Fez, if you puked, would there be any man chowder in it?
All right.
No, but if I farted.
That's the end of tonight's show, ladies and gentlemen.
We're only been on for 18 minutes.
That's plenty for me.
Ronnie, I had to shut him up. Him and his smart mouth.
You shut me up. That's where you got. You shut up your partner. You happy now?
No.
You, your disgusting habits, and the way you describe it to people have ended the show.
And I was
well, thank you for being in tonight. We hope you enjoyed yourself.
That is not the end of the show.
We're going right to the
scene. Oh, thanks, Fez.
You'll get cut up. We're going to take you to the Bronx after the show.
Oh, good. As long as someone's still getting cut.
Yeah.
I got no problem.
Adam. Adam, you're on Ron Fez.
Hello, Adam.
Hi, guys. What's up?
What can we do for you, Adam?
Yeah, well, the drinking thing isn't going to work because you can just drink some olive oil and it'll coat your stomach and stuff and you won't throw up or anything.
Why would anyone drink olive oil if the whole point was to throw up?
If you want to puke, why would you eat something or drink something that made you not do it?
That's a good point.
So think of that before you call in.
Yeah, I don't know. I saw it in a movie.
Who's not in the mood for puking? Everybody loves it.
Nobody likes this. Nobody likes this contest.
I ate too much. I'm going to probably puke tonight. I just do it all the time. It's purging.
What, do you got a pouch?
I'm not a gerbil.
Hey, Mark. Mark, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, how you doing, guys?
Speaking of farting.
Ron and Fez, this has got to be the grossest contest I've ever heard.
It's stupid.
You guys are actually thinking about sitting around a bucket of puke for hours.
Your own bucket.
Guys.
And it seems way too elaborate for you to pull off, Joe Poo.
Yeah.
Do we have any beers? Maybe Joe should try it tonight for us to show us how it
Give
works.
Give it a test run.
Yeah. How about that?
Right now?
Yeah.
I got to drink more water or something.
All right, you drink some more water and let us know when it's time to puke.
You tell us when you're starting the contest, and we'll have a trash can for you.
All right.
And at the end of that time period, you got to puke.
All right.
All right? This is your audition for your contest.
Hey, Kevin, you're on a Fez.
And you're getting cut. Hi,
yeah,
Kevin.
I think he's studying everybody should puke on Joe.
All right, we weigh Joe. They puke on him, then we weigh him, and we see how much
that's the
extra weight. Yeah, he can just cup his hands, and then you puke into his hands, and then see how much he weighs after each one.
No, I don't like that idea, and you're not working here. You can't come up with these ideas.
And what's with that voice? What is this, West Side Story?
When you reject, you're jet all the way. Tell me for a cigarette. Forget it.
It what? Takes place in Bayonne.
All right, hold on. I've been invited to some kind of game online, some kind of chat room. Fez, you want to go?
No, I don't go into chat rooms, Ronnie.
I don't know what the name of it is. Let's see. Pooter Toot is in there. Rooster. And well, how would you say this? E-I-L-I-A-L.
Elia.
Elia.
Why would there be Elia Chat 54? There's 53 chats before this one.
What are they playing?
I don't know what the hell they're doing in there. Big Jim is in there. It's ridiculous. Too Cute is in there. Taz. Don't invite me to rooms. It's just they weird me out. There's chat rooms. It feels like you're going to get jumped at any second. 877-692-1027. Let me say, here's Eric. Eric, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, Eric.
What's up, boys?
Yeah.
What can we do for you, Eric?
Okay, listen, I have the perfect contest for Joe Poo on Friday. This is what you have him do. You bring in a whole bunch of listeners, eat a whole bunch of food, and then you give him X-Lax. Whoever holds it the longest
wins. My God.
And it fits into his name. Come on, Ronnie. I know the stench won't be that bad, and it's Friday. You get to go home and don't have to worry about
That's
it.
The only part I would let the puke go through. So, yeah, why not do a poo contest, Joe?
That's disgusting. Are they going to eat it?
No.
Hey, Alan, you're on Ron and Fez.
Yeah, how you doing, guys? You guys got a hot little lesbian there, and you're talking about puke?
Well, here's the problem, man. We do have a hot little lesbian. Let's describe you a little bit, too.
Okay.
Liz, how tall are you?
About 5'2".
She's 5'2". I love the petite.
Mm-hmm.
And you got red hair and just these almost innocent freckles.
Uh-huh.
Almost what I'd call innocent freckles.
Yes.
I'd say you weigh about, I'll say 102.
Yeah, you can
in that
say
area.
That.
And the breast... Or as Al put it, what cans she has. He calls them cans.
Nice.
Thanks, Al.
What,
I thought he was talking about her headphones.
What size bra are you with?
About 34C.
34C, and they're yours? They're real?
Yes.
And how old are you?
20.
Oh, Lord.
Just turned 20.
Barely legal.
And sitting here waiting for Crazy Claire.
That's right.
Now, here's the only problem. Will Claire show?
I hope so.
Will Claire show?
You never know with Claire. She could be in lockup right now. We don't know it. She could have her arms tied behind her back, and we're just not aware.
Claire, get down here. I want to meet you.
Or perhaps her train is a little late.
Yeah, maybe that's it.
Maybe it's something that simple.
Who knows, Fezzy? But with the insane, you have to expect the worst.
Right, always. And the day we end up figuring out Crazy Claire is the day they lock us up.
Sure. That's the day we'll be in there with her. Going, oh, I get it now.
Oh, so this is how it feels.
Right. Right. Either that or we'll just, we'll let you cut the clothes off of Joe Poo.
Oh, okay.
All right.
When did you start realizing you were in the chicks? What age?
When I met my... girlfriend.
Yeah. So
I met her online, actually.
Oh, God bless this.
And, yeah, really. And we met about after 2 months of talking online.
What chat room was it?
It
curious?
Was, I just, like, you know when you just find people and you just IM them just to start talking to someone.
Right.
So we just had a lot of things in common. And
did you start talking nasty before you met?
Yes. So when we met, and she's younger than I am, so... Her like I when I went there, she lives in Virginia. Her parents, like, it's her parents' house, so we had to be really, really quiet.
So exciting.
It was really fun.
And they
it's
thought
a movie.
And they thought, oh, how nice, her daughter has a sleepover friend.
Yeah, and they're, like, really, like, it's, like, in a Christian southern, like, little quaint town, and, like, after a while, like, we'd, like, I'd be in the shower with her, and they'd be like, why are you in the shower with her? You shouldn't be there. And so we had to kind of, like, make up stories and stuff, and people were starting to get curious, so.
Bi-curious. They were getting bi-curious.
Thinking same. What did you say when they said, what was your excuse for being in the bathroom together?
Well, I just said, like, I was just sitting there waiting for her to get out of the shower, and we just talk.
Night cover.
Yeah, right.
Well, they didn't
That's
know.
That's the one Fez used
they
with his
nephew.
They
still don't know.
Oh, there was a problem with the plug in here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh, he stopped up that drain again.
And Joe Poo takes his showers with his own sister.
I do. It's very attractive.
Every Saturday night.
But you say there's nothing wrong with it, because how do you take showers?
Cheek to cheek, Roman tuck.
They ass to ass take showers.
So that the worst that touches is a pair of cheeks each.
It's not breast to breast. That'd be too weird.
All right, Al.
They don't match up either.
I want to point out to Al. Since Liz is sitting next to me, why don't we not put up on the computer Lesbo every time we're talking about our wonderful new friend, Liz?
Why use the politically incorrect
it's
terms?
It's all right.
Just put Liz up there.
I used to get called Lizzie the Lezzy.
Really?
Yeah, in elementary school. I think it kind of sealed my fate.
So, give us a famous person you first got curious about.
See, I was always, like, girls would have pictures of, like, cute little guys on their room. And I'd always have pictures of girls. But I didn't know, like, I didn't know why or anything. I just was never really into guys.
Who were some of the girls you were first into?
Oh, God.
Like Joe Poo used to have a Betty Grable up on his wall.
Still does, I think. He took it down once he got the Betty Grable tattoo.
That got me through the war.
Who were some of those pictures up in your room?
The Party of Five girl?
No, I was...
Nev.
I'm into music, like classic rock music. So one of my favorite singers is Stevie Nicks, so...
Sure.
She's very fine.
Don't put any recent pictures of her up on your wall.
She's still gorgeous.
She's dating Shallow Hal.
Oh, she could date me.
Her new album is called After. Oh, it's an exciting story, Fez. It's an exciting story. And now tonight, sight unseen, or you've seen her pictures.
Yeah.
But you want Crazy Claire to cut your clothes off.
Sure.
So exciting.
Just here to see what happens next. It's thrilling. The adventure you're on.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, this girl for you?
Sorry, I love this song.
Go ahead and bounce up and down, though. We don't mind.
Well, you picked this one.
Yeah, what does that even mean? Yeah, right. Why this one? Where?
It's a hit for me.
Who, you Dick Clark?
Drop the Clark, and that's who he is.
And you covered it.
Don't use the term Clark, and you got it. All right, hold on. Patrick does have a question. Hey, Patrick, you're on Ron and Fez.
How you doing? Liz, a question. Now, you're just turned 20, but you've come off of two long-term lesbian relationships?
Well, long-term for teenage years, maybe 6 months. So that's long-term for me.
Sure.
Long-term in dog years.
Hey, let me tell you something. I have had marriages that didn't come anywhere close to that.
Joe Poo.
I think it's fine.
That's for sure. It's like I was constantly moving your stuff.
Shout out to Bayonne.
Sure, everybody loves Bayonne.
Bayonne.
I got a gig there. Here's Sam. Sam, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Sam.
Hey, Ron and Fez. Liz, why would a cute little piece of ass like you take yourself off the, away from men like that?
That's a good question. Why you cut the men out completely? Something happened to you when you're younger?
Not that I know of. No, I don't know what it is. I'm just not attracted to guys. Like, they're hairy, and, like, I hate body hair, and just, like, armpits, yuck.
Fez, show her your back. Show her your back, Fez.
I am not showing her my back.
All right, let's do it. Let's blindfold her. We'll take Fez's shirt off. We'll bring a yak in, and we just let you feel both.
Do not bring that yak in.
And if you guess which one is Fez, we'll give you the prize. Who wants to play Yak or Fez? Remember to puke into the bag, and it's going on a fish scale. Yeah.
That is not a promotion.
All right, hold on. All right, let's. Some of these guys want to get in on the contest. Hey, Angelo, you're a big puker?
When it comes down to beer, yeah.
Yeah, just beer?
Well, when it goes with the hard liquor, it takes a little more, but with the beer, it sort of forms like a gag reflex.
All right, I'm going to put you on. And every time you go out drinking beer, you throw up?
Yeah, most of the time it doesn't take much beer to do it either.
Do you think that you could throw up enough to win a contest?
Yeah, definitely.
All right, hold on. All right, so he's a possibility.
All right, that's one for Joe Poo Spew for JetBlue.
So stupid. Hey, Bobby Armand Fez.
Yeah, number one, I have a solution to the barforama that's going to take place on Friday. Yeah, I like to vomit at the end of the night just so I don't get the room spins and wake up feeling like, you know, crap. But if we all vomited into a sieve and just measure the liquid rather than weighing it on a meat scale, hello? Rather than weighing it on a meat scale, because, I mean, man, I could be like eating rocks and sawdust all night and then come over there, do a shot, and,
what do you
know,
think
vomit
of the
75 pounds.
Fezzy, what do you think of the sieve situation?
Well, it's another piece of equipment to worry about.
If you vomit into a sieve, then you could use like one of those rain catching barometer things with the little measurements on it. You could just see it right there on the
there's a lot to think about, Bob. Thanks a lot, Bob.
Well, I have another question about this cutie that you have there.
Yes.
Could I ask a question?
Go ahead.
Why is it that when a guy pictures two hotties, you know, making it, that it's somewhat supposed to be exciting, but if you picture a guy taking
it... that
Bob, you can't have that in the air. It's disgusting.
Nice.
Chris, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, what's
hey,
up?
Hey, Chris. Man? Hey, buddy.
What's going on?
What can we do for you?
I want in on the contest.
Tell us a little bit about your puking abilities. Can you puke through a sieve and still win this thing?
Through a sieve, yeah. I'll puke, man. Anytime I go out drinking, I just, there it comes.
You can't help it, huh?
No, I can't help it. I might as well, you know, make something some good out of it.
Yeah.
There seems to
Breaks
be more.
Breaks a peace to the world.
Yeah, there seems to be more of this puking going on than I realize.
All right, hold
on,
Chris.
Man. You know it.
Yeah, hold on, Chris. We'll take your name and
all
number.
Right.
I don't know, I'm sorry you had to come in here on this. We expected to have Claire here for you.
It's still fun.
And it's sad we got Joe Poo with a sieve.
Claire's birthday, you guys are just about the same age. And the situation there is fuzzy. She seems to be mood swinging again a little bit.
Yeah. So it's something that you can watch, but you can't predict.
Yeah.
Right.
You know, and you can't really judge on how you should react either.
I understand she was a little upset with me for not being able to answer her fast enough during the show last night.
Oh.
Online. And you know, it's very difficult to do that, Fez.
Right. A lot of times we get busy in here actually doing a radio show.
Right. Well, don't get mad. All right. So the reason that that you're turned up by guys is their hair.
I that's one of the reasons. I'm just...
What about this? You think you get turned on by an 11-year-old boy?
No.
No hair there. Trust me.
Fezzy, please. Let's not bring that back up, literally.
You know, I like guys with, like, yeah, they kind of look feminine. Like, they have, like, long hair.
All right, give us an example one.
Johnny Depp.
Johnny Depp.
He's kind of girly looking.
Sure.
So if you had to be with a guy, Johnny Depp.
Yes.
Your parents know you're gay?
I think they kind of suspect it.
Right.
Haven't really said it, so.
Why do you think they suspect? What's come up?
Well, first they suspected my whole first relationship with my girlfriend, because I'd always leave and drop everything and just go out to see her.
She needs me!
And
we haven't finished dinner!
And my mom's always like, how come you never date boys? She's always trying to set me up on with dates. On,
explain the Harry thing to him.
Oh,
she should
understand
that.
No, she won't understand.
So she actually asked you about dating the girls?
She always asks me.
Okay.
And what do you say?
No? I say, Mom, stop.
How many times did I say that when I was a kid?
Too many. Way too many.
Fez,
no child should have to.
And then Fez had to yell, Dad, stop.
Well, eventually stop.
Oh.
All right, here's Joe. Joe, you're on Manifest. Hey, Joe.
Yeah, I want to ask that cutie pie if there's any chance that she thinks this might be just a phase she's going through, that she likes carpet and clam and bearded clam.
All right, we'll check. You think this is just a phase?
I don't know, maybe. I mean, if I see a guy and I just like him, then I'll go out with him. I'm not against going out with a guy.
Okay, so that's not ruled off completely.
No.
Ruled out.
All right, a Johnny Depp type guy you would be fine with.
Yeah.
To Billy.
877-692-1027.
All right, Fezzy, here's somebody on that wants to talk to Liz. It's Hot Liz.
Oh.
Ooh.
She's Hot Liz. Got a nice pair of them.
Hot Liz.
Hi, guys. The song's getting old.
Yeah, it really is, isn't it? That's Sarah Six.
Some people don't even have one.
Yeah.
I'm a little upset.
Why now?
Have I been replaced? Is there a new Hot Liz?
No.
She likes the song.
You're out, baby. You're out.
That's not nice.
No, she's not, she's just named Liz, but she said she was...
But she's Liz and she's hot, so I was just wondering if I've been replaced.
Well, I didn't even think of that, Fez.
How about...
Yeah, how easy it would be.
How about...
She's lesbian, Hot Liz?
Yeah, she wanted to go with Lizzie the Lezzy, is what she was called as a child.
Right.
But that's immature for us, I think.
But they called me that, too, when I was little.
Did they really?
I'm as straight as they come.
Oh, literally. Come. She said come. You've never been with a girl, Liz?
Other than that escapade at the roadshow thing.
Oh,
but no.
See?
That was just a kiss.
I know that was a good escapade.
I didn't know that was a first-time situation for you.
At first and only.
That's a good foundation, though.
Yes. And guess what, guys? My birthday's next week.
Really? Let's have a party for you?
The 15th. It's going to be 23.
See, that's a little old for us. We got Lizzie the Lezzy here. Now, we'd love to have you come in. No,
what
come
day
on.
Is it, Liz? Hot Liz?
It's next Thursday.
What's that date?
The 15th.
The 15th, okay. I'm writing it down. Oh, I'm sorry. We're having the other Liz in that.
Bro,
night.
Are
Don't
we
do
really?
That, no.
It's already on the calendar, Ronnie.
Not very nice.
Well, why don't we just send pictures of the new Liz with us at the studio and mail those to you?
You guys are harsh.
It'll be like almost being here.
Right.
All right, I'm going to go.
All right, we'll see you for your birthday.
All right.
All right, Hot Liz.
Bye.
We'll see you on the 15th.
Dang.
Walking on eggshells around here constantly.
So hard to hear from the washed up ones.
Yep.
I love Hot Liz.
Yeah, but, you know.
She's Hot Liz.
It's not just a song that's getting old.
A nice pair of them.
This song is played. 877-692-1027. It's the Ron and Fez Show.
Ron and Fez. 1027 WNEW.
We met a new friend tonight. We're Ron and Fez. Her name's Liz.
It's just Liz.
Just Liz.
Just Liz.
You know, Fezzy, we will always love the first Hot Liz.
Sure. We can't help it if people are named the same.
Classic Liz, as she's called. Now,
Classic Liz.
Are we being stood up by Crazy Claire?
No, I think she'll be here. She just always runs late.
Is she late every time?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
I don't remember. I never asked her about it. She's always got a knife.
Yeah, she's always late.
Normally, when a woman tells me she's running late, I start getting nervous. And I start saying, well, how much is half in a ride? That seems like enough. If I pay half and give you a ride.
877-692-1027. Our new friend Liz actually came here tonight to meet Crazy Claire.
Yes.
All right, hold on. Now he gives me, Al gives me a note, and he says he's got a special guest. Like, we don't know she's already booked, but we all have to shut our eyes, and she'll give us an audio clue.
Okay.
All right, so we got our eyes shut. Where is she?
All right, eyes
Joe,
are closed.
Joe, is your eyes shut? Mine is shut. See if I can guess who it is.
All right.
Hi, Ronnie. Hi, Fezzy.
Ah!
Ah! Hi. We know who it is.
No, I didn't mean to come in, but Paranoid was in town, and he really wanted to come in.
Oh, yeah.
So he has to pick me up what just happened.
What happened?
I'm waiting for Al to come down. We're waiting. And he's like, I'll be right back. And he just appeared.
Paranoid?
Yes.
He got paranoid?
Yes. He, yeah.
Now, what is he doing here?
No, that's the thing, is he wanted to come up, and he was trying to get his camera.
But, you know, there's not here.
I know. But he booked a hotel room. He's like, all right, I'm coming up anyway. So I was like, okay, I work in the city. Let me take you. We went out to eat. You know, I was like, we'll go out to eat.
Is something happening with your own paranoia?
No.
The crowd just hates him.
No, he's all right. He's a good person, but.
No, he's not. He's a mad dog.
Oh, no. He's just a little crazy.
Here's the situation. He's worried about his camera. I don't have it here yet.
I know.
I can't say. And the person who does have the camera said, please don't say that he left it here. Oh. So I hope he doesn't know who has it.
No, he doesn't.
Because that person already fears him.
Oh, no, really?
Yes.
Everyone does.
People fear him.
The crowd hates him.
No, all I can say is I certainly don't fear him. I think he's...
Look at you. You're adorable.
No.
By the way, this is Liz, and not hot Liz.
Hi, Melissa.
It's a whole different Liz.
So cool to meet you.
And this, of course, is...
Sweet Melissa.
Who isn't tired of her song?
Right. You still like your song, right?
I love it.
Heckler wrote to me, Fezzy. He's mad that he doesn't have his own song.
You know, they gave me a song for Heckler, but it just doesn't work. And he talks over his intro. And
right.
So, and there's a lot of vocals at the beginning of his song. And I really just had to 86 the whole thing.
Good.
So if Heckler wants to have another theme song and he has a suggestion, that's fine. He can email
it. I think he had
in.
Some wrestling song that he wanted, a Dino Bravo tune or something.
Please.
So you staying with us all night, hon?
I was really bringing Paranoid in. I didn't know.
And you lost him.
All right, but you're sane enough to know we don't have his damn camera. And he came 600 miles for something without checking.
I know.
Did he check with Al?
He said, I told Ron I was coming in Wednesday, so it seemed like an okay thing to me. And he booked the whole thing, like, last minute. So he's like, I got a good deal, I'm coming up.
Damn that hot wire.
Yeah, really. It really was hot wire.
Was it really?
Yeah, honestly. On my recommendation.
Oh, jeez.
People are getting too good of deals, now they're showing up at our door.
He flew up?
No, he got a good hotel room. So he drove up and he got a great deal right on Times Square. And he disappeared.
I know when we rode to the bar crawl with him, he was completely enamored with Times Square.
Yeah,
right.
I brought him back there.
Lights.
And he was just, this is amazing. He's like, I look like a freak. I can't keep my eyes off, like, looking up and forgetting.
That would be in any city, USA.
Was he tripping?
he's always high. You know,
he must not have any lights in his own apartment.
We have a brand new mayor. I don't want this to happen.
What if Mayor Bloomy sees this guy? He's so embarrassed.
We got to our hotel room, and there was someone in our room already. And it happened to be...
Was your porridge gone by any chance?
And it happened to be Middle Eastern. So, and forget it, Paranoid was freaking...
He should be freaking.
Because the guy was, like, on our phone and just, like... And then there were people on the roofs by the hotel, and he...
Keeping an eye on stuff?
Yes. He thinks everybody's watching him. Yeah.
Wait till he sees what we put him through tonight.
Oh, no.
Well, I can't even call the person who has his camera, because that person already thinks he's a maniac.
That's fine.
And I said, no, I won't let him know that you have it.
That's, you know... It's
although I know he got to figure out where it probably was left.
So he left his camera at the bar crawl?
Something
somewhere.
Like that. He doesn't remember where he left.
Either here, the bar crawl...
Oh, somewhere along the trail. The long trail from
they're probably not
Virginia
the trail
to here and back again.
Right.
Yes. Location. Think of. Yeah. But, so, yeah, he's here for no good reason.
Then. Tell us that you're not with him.
Always.
Oh, no, heavens no. Heavens no.
You seem enamored with the maniac.
He's funny. And he
funny
can't,
to laugh
he,
at?
He can't even look at me. Yeah. We ate dinner together, and he didn't look at me.
You're making fun of his glasses, weren't you?
What was he eating?
That's that one eye.
He couldn't eat in front of me. He really didn't touch his food. It was a chicken sandwich. He didn't touch it.
You got it with you?
I didn't bring it. He wanted to bring you.
Was he too paranoid to eat it?
He thought I would make fun of him if he ate it.
Look at you, eating food.
Right.
Food eater.
Eating the stuff you ordered.
Like a maniac ordering off the menu.
Well, I wish we knew you were coming in. I would have got you some wine. We said we'd have wine next time.
Oh, no, but I'm fine. I'm fine.
Well, we got a cute girl for you if you're interested.
She's beautiful. Yeah. Thank you. Wow.
Are we thinking a little introductory kiss before we get going?
Does she want a kiss? I'm never shy.
Yeah, we know that.
Well, maybe she's looking at me.
Yeah.
I'm up for anything.
Oh, here we go, Fezzy. Here we go.
Oh, my God.
I'm just going to fall out of the chair to get to the other one.
Now she's worried about a chicken sandwich on her. Oh, Lord. Oh, my God. Two girls next door making out for us.
That was a good long one.
Yeah.
That was a good long one.
I'm so proud of you.
I'm clapping, but I'm not using my hands.
What are you saying that is?
I'm not.
Your nads? You saying your nads are slapping together?
He calls them clackers.
Now, Melissa, Liz, how'd you like that? You enjoyed it?
Yes, I did.
See, aren't you glad you came now?
Very.
We didn't stop, because I said came, right? I didn't mean it that way. So even though we haven't seen the girl you came to meet, you got the, you know, very beautiful, sweet Melissa.
Very beautiful.
Crazy Clair, on the other hand, who knows what she's doing.
Right.
Stabbing a dog right now? I don't
Could
know.
Could be. She may have gone to dig up her cat. We don't know at this point. All we know is that her birthday party is going on without her.
I know this. Fez and Paranoid are heading out to party after the show tonight.
No, no, no.
He got the room for you.
The crowd can't stand him.
He got you the Afghan suite.
Boo.
You guys
Boo.
Are staying in the Afghan suite.
Yes.
Like a gay Bin Laden party.
I don't even know what a Bin Laden party is. I don't know what a gay one would be like.
Hey, Eric, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Eric.
Hey, guys, what's going on?
Hey, what can we do for you, Eric?
Hey, I'm very interested in this contest. We used to do this for distance.
What contest? Oh, you're back to puking again.
Yes.
Puke for distance? What do you think of that, Joe Poo?
That sounds fantastic. Joe Poo's idea is finally taking off. How can you measure distance with a meat scale?
Well, that's where you just stand on the street. Place a line, and then everyone goes from there.
All right, hold on. I'm going to put you on with Joe. The whole puking thing, Fuzzy.
Joe, all your pukey friends are calling
now. Right. Hey, Rob, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, yeah. Rob.
How's it going? I got the tolerance of a goldfish here, so I'm all for this puking thing.
All right, that would mean that you could drink a lot, right?
Well, no, you drink a little bit, and then you're done. You shouldn't be drinking anymore.
I would think that a goldfish would be able to drink more than most mammals.
Oh, we'll see. Well, I don't know. Drop a goldfish in a bottle of vodka and see how it does.
All right, hold on.
Probably wouldn't last long.
Boy, the puke guys are just weirding me out now. Between that and being stalked by Paranoid, it's just too strange. Here is... Joe, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Joe.
Hey, guys. I might have the possible whereabouts of Clair.
Yeah.
Rumor has it that today she stole a logging truck and drove it through Dallas.
Was that her? That thing was a mess.
I missed the news.
What happened,
so Fez?
I guess the guy stole a logging truck. He's driving it through. It's just taking it everywhere, on the road, off the road. The logs start spilling off of the thing. He almost hit a short bus. You see it on the footage.
All right, good news. Crazy Clair has arrived.
All right.
All right, now, well, hold on. We'll go to a break, Fezzy. When we come back, Melissa, you'll come over with me now. Fezzy, and we'll hook these two up. You can share over here. Because we don't want Clair to see you yet.
Oh, okay.
Because you're kind of her birthday present.
Right. Okay. Birthday surprise.
Melissa, you can enjoy her as well.
Yeah.
Everybody gets a piece of the cake.
Nice.
Fez, you'll be with Joe Poo. Hawk, I guess you're with Al.
I don't go that way.
And I'll leave with Melissa. Hey, I
Al, I trade you.
I had. You're always thinking of us. All right, who did Al get?
Al got Hawk.
Ah.
I got Joe Poo.
Ah. Well, I'm sorry, you're more attracted to Hawk, are you?
Than Pukey?
Don't hurt him. All right, so we'll take this break, and when we come back, and I don't think this has ever been done on the radio, Fezzy. Lesbians.
Okay.
It's a brand new.
A first.
Wow.
Brand new radio concept.
Gonna break some ground tonight.
Yeah, breaking ground. But one of them cutting the clothes off of her, hopefully a new friend.
Okay, great.
All right, so don't go outside. I don't want her to see you yet.
Okay.
Okay?
Because you're kind of like a birthday present for
okay,
her.
Okay, good.
Put on a bow or something.
It's 877-692-1027, The Ron and Fez Show.
Ron and Fez. 1027 WNEW.
Shavers.com, the online leader in shaving products, proud to announce the opening of their beautiful new showroom, 30 West 57th Street in Manhattan.
Shavers.com, Fezzy. Log on to Shavers.com for a huge selection of electric shavers and trimmers from all the major manufacturers with all the latest models.
That's right, and Shavers.com can even help you if you have special requirements like sensitive skin or a tough beard. Shavers can help you make the right choice for your special shaving needs.
Fezzy, don't tell this to sweet Melissa, but I plan on getting her a shaver for Christmas.
Nice. Way to go. I think she heard you.
Melissa, do you shave all the way?
I do.
How about you, Liz?
Yes, I do.
Completely, 100%?
100%.
You see, you girls should go to Shavers.com. You'll never have another problem.
Another couple of satisfied customers at Shavers.com.
I just bit my lower lip.
Ouch.
I bit the boy on my lower lip. Just being so excited by you girls.
24-hour online availability, discount prices, fast shipping, and free shipping with every order over $60.
Check them out online. That's Shavers.com or give them a call at 1-877-SHAVE-YOU-2.
That's 1-877-SHAVE, the letter U, the number 2. Or visit their brand new showroom at 30 West 57th Street and let their friendly, knowledgeable staff help you. Shavers.com. We shave the world for less.
Visit your Tri-State Saab dealer today.
Ron and Fez here to tell you about Sam Adams and the Sam Adams Brew It Yourself TV commercial contest in conjunction with Project Greenlight.
Fezzy, don't tell Melissa, but I'm getting a shaver for her birthday.
Really?
Yeah.
Mom's the word.
Mom's the word. Because both these girls completely shaved?
Mm-hmm. Yes, of course.
Liz, completely shaved?
Completely shaved.
You know, we get them a shaver.
You're not whispering.
And, Fez, you said something about Project Greenlight or something like that.
That's right, with the Sam Adams Brew It Yourself TV commercial.
Oh, yeah,
contest.
That's right.
It's your chance to write and direct a Sam Adams Boston Lager commercial.
Winner also receives $5,000 and a year's supply of Sam Adams.
Nice. To participate, submit an idea for a 30-second Sam Adams TV commercial at projectgreenlight.com. And then while you're there, review 6 other competing entries.
Who's to say how much a year's supply is? For me, it's going to be a lot more than for some guys.
Sure. Contest begins on November 26th of this year, and your contest ideas have to be in by December 3rd.
You got to be 21 to enter. See the website for a complete set of rules.
It's the Sam Adams Brew It Yourself TV commercial contest.
Ron and Fez, 1027 WNEW.
It's a happy birthday song. We're Ron and Fez.
We got Crazy Claire coming in for her birthday, Fezzy, and our birthday present is Liz. This is the email that Liz sent us the last time Claire was in. I was listening to the show yesterday when Claire was on, and I wanted to call so bad, but I was on my break and couldn't get to a phone. Anyway, I think Claire is totally hot, and I would so, gigantic so, love to, well, you know. She says she's been craving girls, so here I am. I'm 20, very cute, correct, and bisexual. So if you guys want to go along with this idea, I'm totally willing. So that's fun.
Yeah.
That proves you're a fun girl.
Signed, yeah, Liz.
Now, Liz in here, totally, totally cute.
Thank
5'2",
you.
She said 102, Fezzy.
Uh-huh.
Red hair. Little freckles, tiny little happy girl next door freckles. Perfect smile. Is that it? You describe them, Melissa.
She's beautiful. She has her hair pulled back behind her ear. She's got gorgeous auburn hair, dark, dark brown eyes. This beautiful nose and her smile is just amazing.
Oh, thank you so much.
I can spank to her descriptions. If I have one of her books on tape, Fezzy, I'd never need to be in another relationship.
Melissa, you're going to start writing our resumes.
Rad and Fez would like to come work for you. All right, so we're going to bring in Crazy Claire. You know she likes the knives, so don't get too scared.
Right. She comes armed.
Here comes Claire.
Woo!
Claire, this is Liz.
Hi, Claire.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Claire, just absolutely beautiful. Oh, God, look at the size of the knives.
Big knives.
Happy birthday to you, Claire.
Thank you, guys, very
Happy
much.
Happy birthday, Crazy.
Now, lately you said you've been mood swinging a little bit, though?
Yeah, in the fall. I have seasonal depressive disorder or something.
Really?
Yeah, so.
No, but it's every season.
Well, no, it's just
it's when baseball's over. I get the same way.
Oh, sure, yeah. It's in the fall and winter and stuff. But I don't know. I'm doing all right. I'm getting acupuncture done.
Does that help?
Well, they're going to try.
They've
ran the gamut with drugs. They thought they might go.
Have you ever tried acupuncture before?
Yeah, I've had it before. It's pretty cool, actually.
Yeah, I used to do it for a while, too.
Is it okay to give a cutter acupuncture, or is that just going to get you all lit up again?
No, that'll just make me like, finally, I'm home.
Okay.
I'm happy.
Right.
Yeah, I had a couple acupuncture things where it was almost trippy.
Yeah, so I've had ones too, where you get in like this weird state of mind. And
the only thing is, I ate mushrooms before I went there.
Oh yeah,
yeah. And then they're
might not have been the acupuncture at all.
And then they're like putting these little pins in me, and I looked up and I went, "Am I beef?" And they go, "No, you're high. You're just high."
Did you get them to stick in your ears? Those are the most painful. Those are the addiction ones.
You know, one time I actually left there because a lot of times it feels like even like you're doing downs, and I left, and I'm driving home, and I'm like, my leg's been killing me. I get home, I take my pants off because you're like in your underwear when they do it. I had two of them still in my leg.
Yeah, that's happened to me before. They leave needles in.
I go, there's so many, it's hard to keep track.
I go, how the hell could you forget this?
I don't know.
And one's sticking in my leg, I'm driving home. And I called up, I go, what am I, beef? I'm just, you know, start becoming my thing with them. You know what I mean?
What's your beef?
Right. All right, so I look over Liz. What do you think of her?
I think she's very beautiful.
Now, she's been in only with two girls, but both long-term relationships.
Oh,
for her. I mean, she's only 20. How long-term could they be?
Right. You start to chew into junior high time.
Right. That was my... No. All right. How about you? Have you ever really been in a relationship?
No,
or?
I haven't. I don't have a problem with it. I just...
Yeah.
I
you haven't met the right girl.
Yes, I haven't met the right girl. I haven't been in many relationships. I'm a little too...
Yeah, a little too nuts.
Yeah.
You keep going away.
Now, I know that you saw her picture online.
Yes.
But does it worry you that she... I mean, here she is. She comes in kind of... You know, she almost didn't come in today because she thought I blew her off last time. And it's all made up. All, literally, why would I do this with my guest? Right? It's just completely crazy talk. There's something spring in her brain. I don't know.
I'm a little neurotic.
You know the biology thing, but is there springs in your brain?
Sure there are.
Right, so there it is.
She popped a coil.
She popped a coil in her brain.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Now, here's something very interesting. Because, Claire, you're doing, when you look at Liz, you're doing the same thing I'm doing. You go down to the breast. And girls complain about that. But girls who like other girls, you go down to the breast.
Yeah,
right?
I don't know what it is.
See, a guy will never...
Like, I think
guy.
It's the breast.
A guy, other than Fez, will never check another guy's bulge.
Well, you don't know. Maybe if they're gay or...
Or have somebody in Ontario, Canada.
A fiancé.
All right, so what you really wanted to do, we're going to find some kind of strange music tonight.
Okay.
And have you cut it close. And let's face it, we did this with you on the O&A show.
Uh-huh.
And it was a bomb because of...
Get your balls out!
Oh, there you go.
We had
it was funny, but it wasn't very erotic.
Right, we had the Glimmer Twins, Fez and Mario Cantone.
We are not now known as the Glimmer Twins.
You know how Fez had a little thing for...
Get your balls out!
Mario is very attractive, he is.
Right.
I think they would be perfect.
Apparently, according to Mario, too attractive for our Fez. So he heard
doesn't even know I'm alive.
Aww.
No, he knows you're alive. He just hates you.
All right, so that, I think, is even worse.
That brings me back to high school.
When you like somebody and they don't like you.
Mario Cantone went to your high school? What was he like?
Please.
Mario Cantone, when he went to high school, Little Italy was a dirt road.
Ronnie, he is above us. Please. He did Steam Pipe Alley.
Just because you're on your knees is the only reason he's above you. If you stand up and look at him out of them eyes to sack.
We can only hope to get to Steam Pipe Valley one day.
Now,
there's only like six shows, weren't there?
Is that a gay thing for anal? Steam Pipe Valley.
I can
So who's getting to Steam Pipe Alley tonight? Yeah.
Well, it makes sense. An alley.
Right.
Steam Pipe. Yeah.
The whole pipe situation.
Warmth.
Right. Here's the theme song, of course, to Steam Pipe Valley. All the kids will remember this. Get your balls out!
Oh, we used to sing along and laugh.
Earl's putting away music.
Earl hasn't been here all day, suddenly decided, oh, yes, I need a concrete blonde.
You know, Earl, you want to stay? Give me that bottle of Vicks you're walking around with.
He's got Vicodin?
Yeah, he's got Vicodin.
Oh, my.
He had a tooth pulled today.
Yeah.
Hook it up.
Lock it up.
Nice.
The Spanish Johnny makes the pain go away. I hurt bad. Ron, I can't come to the phone. How the Vikes? You enjoyed them?
I haven't taken it yet.
Yeah, well, my back's killing me. My neck. And
I'm in pain as well. I did three.
Right. Deep end of the pool. Nice to see you, honey.
I got a bottle of ether in the back. Too.
Don't make her pull the knife, Earl.
Earl likes my knives very much.
Yeah,
Earl always plays with the knives when you're here.
He always does. And then he tells me I'm crazy, but he still holds the knife and is still fascinated.
And then we have to get him back from Earl. It's like, where's the knife?
Roy was trying to get it to try to look at it. Earl wouldn't let go.
All right, so do you guys need to know each other a little bit before you start slicing her up? Is there a matter of trust here?
I trust her. Okay.
Oh, my God.
Wow. I'm a very trusting person.
And now
but that might change after tonight.
Joe Poo also wanted to be cut up in little pieces.
Oh, why do we have to ruin it? We're going to have an evening.
Now,
Joe, you'll be the undercard.
I'm going to be busy tonight, huh?
Yeah, you got to work it out for you.
You're like a butcher.
I'm sorry. You won't cut me, Poo. I'll cut you.
That's
what is that?
I have no idea. Some of these are left for me by Roy Hinton. Here's one he liked. That's Clair getting ready.
That springs.
I actually have to sharpen. But
and of course, I heard blood.
That was Earl getting his tooth out today.
My dad always says, "Measure twice, cut once."
He's such a nice boy.
He is. He means
she's
well.
Sharpened it up.
Oh, you can hear the knife being sharpened.
Oh, you can cut a nipple off with one of those.
Oh, you John Rambo?
I love Bowie knives.
Keep talking, Poo. You'll be first.
Yeah, right.
I have a thing for Bowie knives. I think it's like a 70s thing.
Do you know why you like knives so much?
I don't know. I think people just have freakish things that just don't really make any sense.
I'm that way with a spork.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Sporks are rather sexy.
Whereas I am into ladles.
He says it's the only way that he can actually get enough cereal in at one time is have it with a ladle. Maybe you drop some of the ladles and Mario Cantone is interested in you. You learn not to ladle your food in.
The bowls are the same size. It's just that the ladles are big.
That was a dump truck you were eating that cereal out of.
I love cereal.
What is it about that?
I don't know. I'll have it for dinner time.
You're 58 years old. Why do you need so much cereal?
I'm trying to get my daily allowance of grains.
What's your favorite cereal? Fez, what's your favorite cereal?
My favorite cereal is Corn Pops.
Oh,
that's
so
a
good.
Damn good one.
That was my favorite.
I think that was probably my favorite, too.
That's definitely my favorite.
Really?
You can eat it without milk, and it's good.
Yeah, I don't eat any cereal without milk. It's disgusting.
Even the generic is, like, even more sugary.
I don't eat generic anything.
I tell you, it's
so good.
I gotta have, you know, it come in a box, not just that plastic
Ew.
Bag.
What?
What'd I say?
That's the first time you ever wanted to come in a box.
Hey!
Fez eats those little Special K things that you can actually open up the box.
Oh, the variety pack?
Yeah. Remember variety packs?
Oh, when you can pour the milk in?
Right, into the box, which does anyone ever do?
No.
No, No, what you do is you eat it regular, but you pretend you're a giant. You had that box of cereal. You pretend that it's a regular sized box.
Really?
Uh-huh.
Now, I've done this before.
I would do this. Right? I would take that little box and then open it up like that, and then put a soldier inside, pretend I had a nice little cabinet TV.
Oh, nice.
Wow,
war film on again.
Yeah. You ever do this too? How close do you sit to that cereal box when you're a kid?
Oh, yeah.
I would get a couple and act like I had the Great Wall of Cereal.
Oh, right? Yeah.
Nice. All around me.
I'd make barriers so I wouldn't have to look at my sister.
Really?
Yeah, we would do that.
You like to mix cereals? See, I'll mix them.
Can't. I'm not. No, I think it's into purity. You know?
Really?
Yeah. Nothing more pure than Honeycrisp.
I can't mix them. It's just not right.
All right, we got two hot buy crazy chicks ready to slice each other up, and we're talking favorite cereal. This is why we're on at night, Fez.
We're going to get it right yet.
We effed up bad. All right, people writing in about poor Fez. Poor Fez. That's sad.
What's wrong with
that? Yeah,
the ladles, the cereal, what? There's so much tonight.
The fact that you never got called from.
Get your balls out.
After Opie made him promise to call.
Did he really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Nothing.
It's pretty flaky, if you ask
Zilch.
Me.
Yeah, sick. And then you almost didn't come tonight after we got this beautiful surprise present for you.
I have trouble.
Seriously, thank us.
Thank you so much. I have trouble getting here. The subway's really difficult to get. I don't know.
Do you two want to do like a little kiss and get it out of the way?
I don't know.
Yeah, I think
Except
so.
You, Claire.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm going to need all kinds of sexy music.
Right, sexy music.
I want saxophones. Right. Saxophones.
Saxophones.
What kind of saxophone music?
I don't know, like cheap porn sax, you know, like
sax, cheap porn sax.
Saxophones, the saxophones they play in, like, Skinamax.
Something cheesy, I don't know how many saxophones are in it.
I will pick it up, we'll be okay.
Oh,
wait a minute.
This is good. I want this.
Yeah.
This needs to be the soundtrack of my life.
Yeah, this is the soundtrack from the Cosby Kids. All right, let's see that kiss.
All right.
And make it a nice long one.
Yeah, we're inching over to each other.
Yeah. Make it a nice long one.
Now, this is weird because I don't know her, but that's okay. I've never done this before. I promise. All right.
Okay. Ready?
So
we're going in.
Oh, there they go. All right, now Earl and Al are kissing at the same time.
They're trying to see who can hold it the longest.
They held it longer than us. They won.
You know, sometimes I'm like this. I feel like two bad older stepbrothers making the girls cry. How was that? Did you enjoy?
That was really good.
Yeah, let's get another one out of the way.
Really break up that ice. Not
out
just
of the
break
way.
It, crush it.
All right, are we going in? We're going in one more time?
Yeah, go in one more time.
Okay.
Oh, Lord. God bless them both. A lot of tongue action going on there, Fuzzy.
This is a great birthday. There.
Yeah, I know she does. All right, so they've just met, and I think they're hitting it off.
I think this relationship is starting off swimmingly.
It's starting to work for them both.
It's a good way to start a relationship.
Now,
yeah, on a radio show.
When we get into the cutting, Claire, what else do you do then to make it a little more erotic?
Well, you just cut the clothes off, and you kind of drag them.
You nibble it down there a little bit?
Nibbling?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know.
I know. I think for sure you nibble. I'm fairly positive.
Have you read the manual?
Yeah, I got the manual from the knife company.
The nibbling manual? Yeah, so you cut the clothes off, you drag the knife against the clothes, you know.
Now, you little, and you put the actual knife on her skin?
If she wants to.
Yeah, of course she does. Do you want to, honey?
Yeah. Yeah, sure. Sure, why not? I haven't killed anyone yet, so... Don't
yeah, that's
this.
Good to know.
Very good.
Well, there is a cat we're not sure about.
Oh, my poor kitty. Oh, he fell to his death. It wasn't me. I didn't push him.
Did I say it, or was that the
anyone.
Voice in your head?
No, people...
Was that the voice in your head?
People accused me of killing my cat when I called up the day when I was crying and laughing at the same time.
Well, the problem was, and I'll just point out to this, Key, this, I know that you're a little... You know, a lot of crazy people, they're into their own head.
Mm-hmm.
So the day that you called crying about your cat, I think that was September 12th.
Uh-huh.
No.
And most people were yeah. a little more upset about the towers.
There was other things on people's minds.
It was more like September 15th or something.
Okay. Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Well,
what I'm trying to say
is... We should have been past it.
Still no funerals yet. And you're like...
Well, I was upset about a lot of things.
I understand.
Well, no, I called in because you guys say I never call. I always sound happy. So I was like...
Right. And I see it in your eyes right now. You're not the same Claire we had before. You look a little sadder.
I am sadder. I don't know why.
Do you feel happy a little bit that you're doing this? Or is this
yeah, no, I have fun when I come to school.
But you don't think this is going to send you in some kind of downward spiral when it's over?
No. I just saw my psychotherapist or whatever, and I'm doing better.
Wow, even the therapist is crazy.
my psychotherapist.
I always get them confused, a psychologist.
Is
there's
it a
so
guy?
I know, there's so many, I can't remember. Yeah, it's
you
a
got a whole staff.
If I was your therapist, I'd make you come in naked. And I said it's the only way I could help you.
That would be interesting.
How many
therapy.
You think of them are having sex with their patients?
I'd say 20%.
Really? That high?
Wow.
That low? All right, when we come back, Fezzy, we will put young Liz up here on the console and let Crazy Claire take out these sharp, sharp knives and slice off her clothes.
All right.
Sounds like a plan.
Yep. It's a first date. It is a first date. Are you excited, Liz, or nervous?
I'm a little bit of both.
Yeah.
Getting nervous. It'll be good,
I think
though.
That's excitement.
I'm just...
Nervous excitement.
Worried about the glossy eyes that Claire has. I haven't seen them before.
So we hope that her aim is still on.
Yeah. I just don't want her slicing on... Oh, what's it all worth? Who cares anymore?
Claire, you have a knife in your hand.
It doesn't matter. There's no God!
Uh-oh.
Claire used to wake up to this every morning when she was in the nut hut.
It's a manhunt! A manhunt!
You don't even know.
And that's go really breakfast! The cook is ready.
When your alarm clock is a fire hose, yes.
No, it was chimes. There'd be chimes.
Really?
Earl, you gotta quit smiling with that bloody tooth.
Yeah.
Bloody jaw. Close your mouth tonight, bro.
Either share the Vikes or get the bloody tongue out of here. Because the only... Oh.
Oh, my God.
Your face has its time of the month.
All right. He did not get his red wings tonight. Did you?
Yeah, it looks like what he's been doing.
Did you finally get those red wings for your brownie badge?
Did you earn them?
No, he got his brownie badge the other side.
Ew!
That's
right. It's a manhunt! A manhunt!
That's not going to get you out any sooner, honey. That kind of talk.
All right, I am so excited about this.
As am I. Thank you very much.
Me too. Very excited.
People asked if you guys would get your pics taken on the web tonight. So if you wanted, I know you don't want to probably do that while you're getting sliced and diced. Flash goes off, and there goes a breast.
Right, yeah.
Oh, excuse me.
Blind somebody.
You can do it before or afterwards.
Whatever you want to do.
I've had actually during.
Yeah, oh yeah.
True.
You were fine with that. That was cute.
Yeah, it was fine. I mean, it's just boobies. So I don't know.
Yeah, right. It's nothing. I don't know why everyone makes such a big deal out of them.
I don't know. Maybe I'm crazy.
Yeah, maybe. Well, you know,
I have papers that say more than maybe.
We have three doctors who say there's no maybe involved. Look, we've given her all the pills we can. Start putting pins in her. See if that helps.
Seriously, honestly, they have me on the maximum doses. I'm on five different medications. They're like, maybe we'll try this now.
there's no, do any of the mood-altering drugs work? Because I talk to people all the time, they're going, oh, yeah, they got me on Prozac. And I'm like, what's wrong? Are you, no, not really, just my regular doctor put me on it. And I go, you just start eating this?
Now they're handing them out like vitamin C.
They put people on Prozac for a lot of different things now, like sleep, cycle.
Right, no matter what it is.
Yeah. Menstrual cramps.
I got
don't
like
know.
14 friends that are on it. And I'm like, does it work? And they're going, I don't know.
Prozac works so much.
I got
a lot
them for gingivitis.
Where'd you get gingivitis?
Bayonne.
Sorry.
I believe him.
I'm just sitting here and Bayonne gets attacked. Even though I did that big your mouse having the time of the month joke and everyone liked it. And I was able to mark that off on my poo sheet for the big meeting that's coming up at 3 o'clock tomorrow. Right, I gotta have another poo sheet ready.
This, you know, Poo's just starting into the business, and we had a big meeting today, and, like, everybody's asking all these questions, and then Joe, he has nothing written down. So you just see him going, Joe, what about you?
Do you guys like jokes on the show or anything?
Just,
I thought maybe I could do some jokes.
And everything's on bar napkins. All his notes.
What if you chase Fez with a bullwhip or something? No, they win the contest by puking. Don't you get it?
That's why we say, yeah, okay, make it happen.
Right.
You make
you
it happen.
You get the meat scale.
Yeah. You get this fish scale. You've been swearing would make the funniest bit of all time. We've got enough people signed up, I believe.
Oh, cool.
Hey, a little later on tonight, we're giving out a trip on JetBlue.
JetBlue Airways, pair of round-trip tickets to anywhere JetBlue Airways flies in the continental United States, the courtesy of JetBlue. JetBlue, it's not the only way to fly, but it should be.
We'll take a break, Fizzy, and when we come back, you'll hear some cunning on the radio.
Yeah, the knife lust will begin.
knife one, lust is a good word.
One hot lesbian cutting the clothes off another hot lesbian with sharp, sharp knives.
There aren't enough lesbians in the world, honestly.
Well, there's
and
more.
One less tonight.
Oh, no.
I see more every day.
We're just hidden in men's bodies.
There you go. I got in that book.
Joe, are you a lesbian?
One. Right off the poo sheet.
Oh, look, he's checking it off.
You take these same jokes, you throw in some puke. We're on our way to Easy Street, boys.
877-692-1027.
Ron and Fez.
Thank you, Claire.
Thank you.
Ron and Fez. 1027 WNEW.
It's cutting time. We're out and fast. 877-692-1027. Crazy Claire is in the studio for her birthday. She just met her birthday present and new friend Liz. Also, sweet
Hello.
Melissa is with us tonight in the studio.
Hiya.
Sweet Melissa is in an observer role tonight, Fuzzy.
And, of course, Joe Poo is with us.
Hello.
Joe,
can you imagine him having phone sex with someone?
Yeah. Then what would you do? Hello? You reach 1-900-BAYONE. Bayonne, babes.
Would you mind calling me brother?
Ew. What does that mean? So you're thinking about your sister?
No, it's just...
He's having phone sex.
Role
he doesn't...
play.
He picks up the extension at home to have phone sex.
Him and his sister are on Dixie cups in the street.
Then, if I ever came out over to your bunk bed, to look out the window at Bayonne makes me so hot. Welcome to Bayonne phone sex line. This is Colleen. What can I do you for? Sure, I'd throw you the high hard one. What's the problem? Hope you're into puking. It makes me so hot. Talking dirty makes my throat hurt.
All right, now someone just said the stupidest thing to me. They go, yeah, Joe will be right back. He's cutting that song. I go, what song?
That song you need. What?
What are you doing in there?
Well, you know the producing staff around here. They just threw a whole thing of papers at me and said, start singing.
And what is it?
What's it about?
It's about tonight. It's to the hot, hot song about, you know, the chicks here.
And is it going to be funny or is it stupid?
Oh, it's hilarious.
And you're singing it?
Yeah, I'm singing.
All right.
Has anybody heard him sing before?
Yeah. Come on, baby, light my fire.
Give us a little sample.
Break on through to the other side of Bayonne.
Did you guys take a picture of him when he was Jim Morrison?
Did we? I'm always Jim Morrison.
Maybe we'll cut the leather pants off tonight.
Jim Morrison with sex on legs.
Hi, I'm Later Days Jim Morrison.
No, he came in with a big beard, so he was like fat Jim Morrison. This is ridiculous.
He even stuffed his shirt really big.
No, he didn't.
He didn't? No.
Fez,
I'm so embarrassed. You guys really don't need me, do you?
No, really. We can make fun of you, you're not even here.
Who else is going to sing?
Oh, right. Springsteen again, right?
All right, so we got some sexy music. Who's going to get the clothes cut off first?
Me.
Now, I don't know why we never take lucky winners for stuff like this, Fez.
Right, that seems like it. Instead, we're looking for people that want to puke.
No. Later on tonight, we're going to be giving out some more JetBlue tickets. By the way, JetBlue tickets for the winner of the RonFez.net football pool. Go to RonFez.net. Round trip tickets to anywhere JetBlue flies in the United States, continental United States.
Including Bayonne, New Jersey?
No, there's no landing there.
Tickets courtesy of JetBlue. JetBlue is not the only way to fly, but it should be.
So go to RonFez.net, play the football pool. My gosh, you win this week. You get a trip from JetBlue.
Yeah. So you got like the L.A. trip on there, the Oakland trip.
Right.
Seattle, Florida.
Everywhere but Bayonne.
Denver, New Orleans.
Unless you got a Cuban flight raft. Is there the flight from Bayonne to Wildwood? Every year we go to Wildwood Crest. It's fabulous. I only take it to get the peanuts.
That's the rich people. We only go to Seaside.
Joe's mom made us some cookies that are out of this world, too.
The Kruszczykis.
Kruszczykis. Yeah. Isn't that Polish cookies?
Yeah, it's Polish food.
Yeah, go get them, because they're fat. Not you. We'll send somebody else.
Someone go get the Kruszczykis.
Not the hawk. We need the hawk. Not you.
Fly Hulk.
We need you.
What about Al? We don't really.
There you go.
Finally.
All right, so you guys wanted some mood music, right?
Yes.
And since the Joe Poo song isn't ready yet.
They're still mixing it.
Yeah, they're still
mixing it. Bayonne Studios in my basement. The sounds of Bayonne. You ever see the TV show Oz? I was in that. I was rape victim number 3.
All right, there's the Kruszczykis that we love. Thank you.
And the song's inside.
These things are so good, Fez.
They are really, really good.
Now, you said your mom had a big deal for these tomorrow?
Yeah, she has to go bring them to a place. They might give her a patent on them.
What? Who's going to patent a cookie?
Mrs. Fields, I want you to taste these. They're Kruszczykis.
Who's your mom? Famous Amos?
These are pretty good.
They're out of this world.
They melt in your mouth.
If we run out of those, there's some Long Island cupcakes still down there.
No.
Yes, please. Thank you. Pass the Kruszczykis. Keep coming.
They're like flaky, aren't they? Yeah, they really are.
No, I can't keep talking that way. All right, let's turn up the music.
Turn it up.
Here is Liz, lay up there. Oh, Joe, help her get up and lay on the council.
Should I take my shoes off?
Yeah, please go. A pair of tennis shoes don't work for me when someone's being having all their clothes.
Look at the laces.
What a little body she has on her, too.
I'm coming.
You will be by the time we're done. And let's get off the sweat socks, too, hon. Let's try to make this a hot thing for a change.
Okay, I'm ready.
All right. Joe Poo is going to help Liz up onto the console. She's up there.
All right.
Swing a couple mics around there.
Yeah. And, of course, here comes the knife action. We'll see how long this is supposed to take.
I'm not ready, baby.
Mario Cantone Fezway.
See if you can beat our record.
Right. Oh, jeez. Oh, this knife is so big and sharp.
She's starting at the collar of the shirt.
Oh, look,
with the point
careful.
Of the knife just
Please
going right
careful.
Toward
you make me so
the throat, right at the
oh,
windpipe.
Are you nervous, hon?
No, I'm just going with it.
Is it exciting?
Yeah, it's very exciting.
How exciting?
I feel the shirt being torn up.
Yeah.
It feels very good, actually.
What about we break it up with a little kiss, just to let her know she's safe?
Yeah, safety kiss.
Is that a safety kiss out of the question, though?
Just let her concentrate. All right.
Yeah. That's okay. We don't
need
to
move the mic.
Yeah.
For a kiss.
Oh, Lord, look it. All right, she's really...
All right, here comes the kiss.
There they go.
It tastes like cookies.
Sugary
powder.
All girls do. Trust me. My old sister Colleen tastes like a gajiki. Oh, Lord. Fez fell down.
My sister tastes like a gajiki.
All right, let's try to... More music. Let's reestablish the mood.
Okay.
How you feeling, honey?
Feeling good.
Yeah.
What's nice is the technique Crazy Claire is using is instead of just slicing right down the front of the blouse, she's actually kind of peeling it off. Of Liz.
Well, I am an expert.
Watch what you're doing.
Watch out for Joe Poo's ass.
Joe Poo, wondering when's his turn?
I say we break it up with another kiss here.
Right. Why rush?
Yeah, we're in no rush.
It's not like the knives are going to get dull.
Yeah. I need somebody on the phones. The phones are just ringing for no apparent reason.
She has a pretty bra, too.
Yeah.
So we'll
slice that up like it's Sharon Tate. You know, the girl's kissing away. And I think deeper and with more respect than any relationship I've ever been in.
Okay.
Yeah.
See, now don't you feel more relaxed about getting the knife taken to you?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. It's exciting to you?
It's different.
All right, she's come slicing back up again. I'm sure there's a payoff, though, honey. Don't worry. If you're not bleeding bad. Oh, God, she makes me so nervous with the knife.
You're like a surgeon, though.
You're a surgeon that's drunk. The surgeon from Rawhide, maybe.
She looks like having my students cut up their frogs.
Oh, God. What a little looker she is, though.
Try not to cut that headphone cord. It's straight over the blouse. I don't want to see an electrocution.
That's how the Titanic went down. That's how the Titanic... Not a soul was saved.
Now, half the blouse is just cut right off.
Right.
Okay, next side.
On the other side, it might be a little difficult.
That's okay.
Just stay very still.
Here, that sword is just slashing around, slicing off her clothes. There's got to be more trust than I even understand here.
It's like Crazy Claire's cutting off little souvenirs of blouse. Little scraps.
Well, you have to do it slowly.
And in pieces.
Not like how
Are you digging this at all, Melissa?
It's pretty hot. I love Liz's confession.
You like them?
Thank you. Yeah, this is a good vantage point.
You can describe them.
She's got this lavender bra on that's really pushing them up. And just looks really hot. Very hot, actually.
Thank you.
All right, now we're going for the pants.
All right, so now the bra is completely exposed.
But you have to save the best for last.
Right, of course. Now just going right up the side of the pant leg, I guess.
I might be out of line here, but I'm getting banged tonight. Trust me. Is that out of line? Just let me know if it made everyone uncomfortable. Right, she's slicing up, heading straight up the legs. Now, here, Fezzy, what I would call the naughty bits and being very quick with that.
Sure, yeah, just slicing right through. Now, Claire, do you ever get the urge, once you got,
a
nice slice there, do you ever get the urge to just start ripping, or does that just turn it all off?
Did you feel metal on skin?
I did before.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Just a little poke.
Yeah, well, you needed that.
Yeah.
Stay awake.
Keep me alert.
We had to give that to you. It's the only way we could be sure you wouldn't talk later. Somebody carded her, didn't they, to make sure she's not 14?
Huh? Oh, I never thought of that. In Bayonne, there's a 3-day waiting period for knives. I worked my sister Colleen over with a wrench one time. Right behind the ear with a monkey wrench. It was the only way we could get her on the helicopter. We were playing A-team.
This is so hot, and we're breaking it up with the Joe Poo stuff.
Now, right now, Crazy Claire working on one single pant leg and going up both sides of it, the inseam and the outer leg.
You know it's a good show when everybody has business in the studio.
Right, yeah.
Oh, yeah, I got to grab some stuff.
People we haven't...
Pretty drunk show.
People we haven't seen in weeks decided, oh, now's a good time to change out those old promo cards. Right.
How you feeling with her down there?
I'm feeling good.
You feeling
it's,
more?
It's going very well.
Are you getting more and more confident with Crazy Claire? Feeling safer and safer, even though she does have a very big, large, sharp knife to you?
Yeah, I trust her.
Trust is what it's about here, honey, because it's too late.
Absolutely.
Her off.
I got to file something down here between her legs. Excuse me. Sorry, ma'am, but you're sitting on the files.
What a looker, little fuzzy. That little, body, just look at the way her chest is heaving up and down because she's nervous like a rabbit that's been caught
in a snare. Crazy Claire, of course, getting to do this. It's her birthday celebration. She's in studio tonight. Next, it'll be Liz's turn with the knife.
This reminds me of the last party Caliglia threw.
Hurry up with the violin. It's getting hot in here. Is Bayonne burning? Someone check. Who played the violin as Bayonne burned? She too, Colleen?
Colleen.
No one knows what the hell we're talking about anymore.
All right, Crazy Claire now working on the other pant leg.
Pants are very thin. It's nice. Good.
She is just slicing up. Now, what's this do for you, Claire? You wish it was on her skin?
What?
You wish you were cutting her skin?
No.
What is it that works for you then?
I don't know. It's like a power thing.
Does it excite you?
Yeah, it's like erotic.
Do you get as much pleasure out of doing the cutting the clothes off, as getting your own cut off?
Yeah.
Wow, it's just as much for you.
Mm-hmm.
What if I put your foot in a blender? Would that help anything at all?
We're having daiquiris. Why did I open my mouth about the blender? Sorry, Colleen.
And Crazy Claire just shredding the pants. Not just cutting them off and removing them, peeling them back, but absolutely shredding them.
She's good with that knife.
Yeah.
You're not done yet, honey.
You're not wearing these home.
No.
It's like the wood chipper scene in Fargo. Steve Buscemi should have gotten an Oscar.
God, what a little body she has, too. Even if you took that knife and cut her head off, she'd still be hot.
We'll see.
Yeah, we'll see.
We will see.
Okay.
All right, so the pants almost cut off. It's weird. They're just in shreds, but the pant leg is still around the ankle. That part's still connected. So it looks like she just came staggering out of Central Park after a really bad night.
Notice as the one lesbian lowers herself down to the bottom.
The cutterfish.
The cutterfish seems to slice away as if to say, when I'm done with this, we're eating sushi.
It's the only fish to fillet itself. I wish we had shows like that in Bayonne. It's all basic cable. Nonsense, Richard Bay. He put the bay in Bayonne.
Melissa, is this working for you still?
This is really, really hot.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
belly, not be as slow as Claire.
Right, sure. That's your problem. You rush your meals.
That's the thing. That's the instinct to rush. Claire refuses to.
It's an art.
When Claire's done with this, she's going to throw her in a pit.
She's already marked some diamond shapes on Liz's back.
She's making a girl snow.
Hey, who cut the skin out of Colleen's back?
Well, she's griping fun, girl.
Yes, that's Colleen. Where is she? I found a moth in her mouth. Don't worry, it was already there.
Oh, now we're around the naughty bits, and she's slicing.
Yep. Now we're actually slicing through the waistband. Crazy Claire cutting the clothes right off of her new friend Liz.
It's a nice way to get to know someone.
Yeah.
I like the way Claire adds commentary like she's Martha Stewart.
Right.
It's great during the holidays. As she just keeps working with her knife.
Wow.
She has nice underwear.
Liz starting to get a little bit more breathy as she realizes there's not much left to cut off. Knowing that the good parts are coming soon.
Oh, yeah.
Uh-oh, that was an ovary.
At least there's two. I can risk losing one.
I found it! Oh, it rolled under the desk! I'll get it!
Found it.
Now, Liz, how's this feel for you? Is it still exciting or just nervous?
It's very exciting. I'm getting more nervous as I'm down to my underwear.
Honey, that's not the word we use on the show.
Say panties.
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 Oh, my God.
Panties.
I'm serious.
Down to my panties. Down to my bloomers.
Oh, my Lord. What a look. Yeah.
Oh.
Nice work, Crazy Claire.
Oh, all right, now we're going for the bra.
Okay, should I get up?
No. Don't you move, honey.
No, she has a knife.
Okay.
No quick movements. That sawing through the strap.
Okay.
That makes a nice pop when that bra strap finally cuts right through.
Do me a favor, Claire. Hold her legs for me, and then I'll get her for you later. What did I say? Something wrong? Let me know. All right, there's lines in this.
Hey!
Show. I thought it was wide open. Now we know. There's lines that can be crossed, okay?
Claire, what's your technique for the bra?
Well, it depends, because sometimes they have the underwire that goes all the way through.
Yeah, I say slice through it.
So you cut the straps. And so what you're going to... Oh. All right, Liz is feeling metal on skin as you're trying to get the bra cut off. Now you're working in an area you can't even see as you're reaching over her body.
I can see.
Ow!
Easy, we just nicked a breast.
Nick my boobie.
Nick my boobie. I think I went to school with him.
Stop it with the Ellie Mae voice, honey. You're ruining everything. Yeah, let's get rid of...
Wow, and the bra has come off in pieces. Claire, you could be hired out for Thanksgiving turkeys.
Oh, my God.
Just carve them up.
Now, Claire, give her a, take a little body shot there.
Take a little body
shot. Take a little enjoyment for Claire. After you carve the turkey, enjoy a little piece for yourself.
God.
She likes the skin.
Yeah. What's going on?
Oh, God, there's the knife across her. She's so frightened. Honey, if you don't jerk around like that, you're losing something important.
Right.
Okay, I'm
sorry. Crazy Claire just running the knife up and down Liz's body and around some of the curves. How is that for you, Liz?
Cold. It feels good, though.
You needed this, honey. Well, just running that knife all over. And I think we're getting a little turned on here, Fizz. Not just the guys, but I'm talking about
I think she likes
Liz.
It.
Make her like it. Make her like it.
Fair knows exactly what she's doing. Just ever so slightly with the edge of that knife and then the tip.
All right, stop teasing us and jab that thing in her heart! Cut her heart out! Ah!
Ah! I got blood everywhere.
Oh, no, really?
I need a Band-Aid.
All right, now is she going to learn to cut yours off?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Let's make the switch.
Should we tag up?
Yeah, let's tag up here. Let's take a little quick break. And when we come back, Fezzy, more slicing.
All right, 877-692-1027. Happy birthday, Crazy Claire.
It's the Ron and Fez Show.
Ron and Fez, 1027 WNEW.
Liz is so bi. Claire has brought knives. It's so hot, hot, hot. Sweet Melissa, will she kiss her? It's so hot, hot, hot. When will they finally get to it? We can't wait. Whip out your... No, I can't do this. No, nothing.
Well, it started cute.
That kind of fell apart. We're Ron and Fez.
That was the Bayonne High School prom theme.
Crazy Claire is here celebrating her birthday. Happy birthday, Crazy Claire.
All right, Claire, before we don't even lie her down yet. Let's talk a little bit. Claire, how was that for you? Was it a nice birthday present?
It was a very nice birthday present.
What you got to do is cut the clothes off of her new friend, Liz. They had never even met before tonight.
And she's very attractive.
Thank you.
Liz emailed the show, said, I've heard Claire on the show before. I've got to meet her. And tonight ended up getting her clothes cut off.
And before we do any more cutting, we'll let people ask questions. 877-692-1027. Was it exciting for you at all, Liz?
It was great. It was definitely.
Was it erotic?
Oh, it was very erotic. I could definitely see the eroticism in knife cutting.
Now, let's say, how close did you get to, let's say, a bingo-type situation? Would you have been close enough? What would have it taken more? How far would you have had to go?
It might have taken a couple more minutes just because I was still a little nervous. So.
Right.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Well, maybe we'll try that later first.
Sure. We got the time.
Now, for you, completely erotic, Claire?
Mm-hmm.
Now, for you, is this something you'll be also thinking about later?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely. I don't know. It's a different experience. The cutting somebody else's clothes off is totally different from having your clothes cut off. It's like a vice versa. Like when you cut somebody else.
What do you enjoy?
I like them both. Having your clothes cut off is like really exciting because it's so like you're so, I don't know, like at a loss of power, and then you have the power with other people. So it's cool. It's cool in both ways.
Now for Fez, we got to cut his pants off sometime, just because that's the only way to get them off.
A lot of times you have to do it just to get me in a cab.
Right. Now Melissa,
I don't bend well.
For you watching that, was it exciting?
I like to watch.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm definitely a voyeur.
Really?
Oh yeah.
And for you also, would it be something that you're thinking about later?
That's pretty hot. Yeah, they're both beautiful, so that's unreal.
Thanks, Melissa.
All right, we're going to do more here.
I've heard it's hot, hot, hot.
All right, here, Ronnie has a question for you. 877-692-1027. Hey, Ronnie, you're on with the Slice Girls. What's happening?
Go ahead, Ronnie.
God, this show was and is awful. It's about as exciting as the 4th of July in Afghanistan. This show.
Yeah, and yet you can't turn it off.
Oh, my gosh, did you wait a long time?
He had it on the whole time. He can't turn it off at all, Fez.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, because it's girls kissing tonight.
Right.
That's why he hated it.
Try later and we have boys kissing. All right, Jeffrey, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Jeffrey.
Hey. Yo, let me ask y'all guys a question. What the hell is going on tonight?
Yeah.
Yo, it's like, sex in the air or something?
It's sex in the air.
Yo, first it's like Opie and Anthony got some sex going on. Now y'all guys, damn.
Well, here's the situation. And we normally don't do these kind of shows, but it's Claire's birthday. She asked for it. And lucky for us, Fuzzy, we were able to find somebody for it.
Right. We honestly didn't even know what Liz was going to be all about till we met her tonight.
No. I like it. I like this. You know what I'm saying? Y'all should do it more often. Do you hear me?
Loud and clear, Jeffrey.
Yo, today is my birthday also, you heard?
Oh, yeah, we here.
Happy birthday.
Yo, thanks a lot, you heard?
Send her all over to cut his clothes off.
All right, then. All right. I'm telling guys, yo, sup!
Sup! Hey, Fezzy. You heard?
You heard me?
I thought that was Earl calling from the other room. I was like, I've never talked that way in my life. What are you talking about?
I thought it was Colleen Poo calling. She's supposed to be in bed by now.
Now let's hear a Joe Poo song again. And really, he says he's very proud of it, Fez, and he told me it was hysterical.
I want him to sing along this time.
Yeah, sing along with him.
Yeah, everyone sing.
Yeah.
Liz is so bi. Claire has brought knives. It's so hot, hot, hot. Sweet Melissa, will she kiss her? It's so hot, hot, hot.
I think that's the best one.
When will they finally get to it? We can't wait. Without your... No, I can't do this.
You stink. You stink.
You suck. You suck. You suck. You suck.
You stink.
The crowd hates it.
Yeah, the crowd has a problem with it.
Yes.
Boo.
Personally, I loved it.
But you didn't mention Chick Flickies or whatever those cookies are called.
Krishickies.
Oh.
Hey, here's Frank. Frank, you're on Ron and Fez. How you doing, buddy?
Hey, Frank.
You two Floridian punks.
Get somebody on the phones.
Yeah.
You know what I would call it, Fezzy?
What?
A communication problem.
Oh, yeah. It probably comes down to communication.
Right. Hey, Mike, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Ron and Fez and Pooh Boy.
Hello.
You guys know what's better than two girls kissing?
What's that?
Three girls kissing.
Now, what about a three-girl birthday kiss?
It's all Melissa, that's her.
Yes,
she's so shy.
Can she say so Mike, shy. Mike while she's doing it?
What do you want? All right, we'll give you a... What do you want? A mic, Mike? Just give him a little mic.
Hi, Mike, Mike.
Oh, I love you.
All right, let's get a three-way kiss.
Is that what's going on here?
Oh, boy.
No, not at all. Sure.
Yeah.
I've never actually understood the logistics of that.
So this is a three-way kiss. Crazy Claire, sweet Melissa, and new Liz.
Oh, Lord, all three together. Was it a little ticklish for you?
What happened? What happened?
They're giggling
Melissa
away with
fell
it.
Out.
Yeah.
Way out.
The logistics are kind of
hard. They're definitely hard.
Six legs.
Maybe what we could do is do like a pass it on, and then you're passing it back.
Hey, why don't you all just get in a pile?
All right, well, let's do Claire's clothes being cut off. Okay. Now, do you have to tell her how to do this?
My little instruction.
I don't know.
Help Crazy Claire up on the console. Under the operating table.
Just do it whatever way you want to do it. I don't know.
Oh, my body, she's got...
You tell that to some people, it's going to be across the throat, Claire.
There you go, you got it. All right.
Okay.
She cuts you twice, still you believe.
A little nervous here. Just cut wherever you want. But don't make it anticlimactic and do it all at once.
Yeah, just slice it. Hey, look at Kimmy Gibbler hanging around outside in Stink. That little couple we're not supposed to know about.
Those two are inseparable. Surgeons would have to separate those two.
They're kissing cousins.
I didn't realize this. Stinky's last name is Gibbler.
Yes, Stinky Gibbler.
I had no idea they were cousins.
They're hanging around drinking free beers. Now, is this something that you two are thinking about doing?
No. You might want to try the other one. The other one might be sharper.
Backseat cutter. All right, so Liz is going to change knives here. Very confident.
Yeah.
Grab right onto that knife, right onto the handle.
Now, Kimmy, do you think you would even want to try this, or it scares you?
No, I'm not really interested. I don't know propositions today.
With those girls from Philly?
Ooh.
What is... Yeah.
Careful with that. You almost sliced to the important parts.
Liz is trying to get a hole there in the shirt, and she's poking the knife right through it, which is, of course, aimed at Claire's body.
It's hard to cut through this.
All right, hold up. Paul's got a question. Hey, Paul, you're on Ron and Fez?
Hey, Paul.
Hey, how you doing? I was wondering if Sweet Melissa can help out with the play-by-play. What's going on there?
Sure, we'll have Sweet Melissa doing a little play-by-play.
There you go, Melissa. You want to get on that mic?
One moment.
That'll help out.
Okay, right now we have a very hot, naked Liz cutting through the shirt, and she's really into it. She's cutting off the top right near Crazy Claire's breast. And,
All right, easy, honey. You take your time.
And, they're, like, really close. So you have Liz's breast very close to Claire's body. So you're dying to see Claire a little naked. And I'm dying to see her skin. And her breast.
Oh. All right, easy, honey.
You know.
We can hold it together.
I know. I think I wish Liz was going a little faster. I know, but she's got to be careful. It's so dangerous. Oh no. I wish I could help. It's really hot. Claire, do you like this, Claire?
Yeah, I like it a lot.
Yeah? What are you thinking, Claire?
About things that I probably shouldn't say on the radio.
You can hear that.
Do you like the idea of a woman cutting her clothes off?
Definitely. I like it a lot.
Doesn't Liz look hot?
She looks beautiful.
Yeah?
This is very exciting.
Didn't she look sexy? She put her coat over it, but you still could see her body.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it was just her coat over her arms and her back, but like you could still see the breast, right? That was really hot.
Most important part.
I can't wait to see her belly. She's getting up towards the front, and it's really scary because I'm afraid she's going to hurt you.
It's all right. I'm tough.
Are you?
I can handle it.
You can handle it?
Yeah.
That's really sexy.
Well, that's the whole thing.
You're doing wonderful, honey. Yeah, you're doing great.
Claire, I'd love to hear you just breathing. You know, do you want her to kiss you right now to soothe you?
If she wants to.
Liz, will you kiss Claire for me?
Absolutely.
Time out for a kiss.
That's good, girls.
Yeah, Joe, you're on the air. How's this coming over, Joe, on the radio?
I don't know if it soothes me as much as it...
Yeah?
Yeah. I dare to say that Melissa is the Howard Cassell of Ron and Fez Show.
Thank you very much.
Later, guys.
All right, that's it.
Melissa rocks.
That's because of the toupee.
Sure. Hey, Colin, you're on Ron and Fez. Hey, Colin.
Okay, first, I'm the grandson of Howard Cosell, and I've got to say, that was freaking hot. But can I get a hoo-ha for that?
Hoo-ha! Hoo-ha!
And right through my car's roof. Good God, Melissa.
Yeah, all right.
On my grandfather's soul, that was some pretty hot radio. God bless you guys.
Thank you very much. Let's put Melissa back on the play-by-play as Liz is slicing the clothes off of Crazy Claire.
She's making some progress here, Ron. If I get up a little, I can now see Crazy Claire's stomach, and it's so flat. She's got a hot little body, and she's moaning. I love that. Keep it up. I like it. You're a good girl. Liz, are you having a good time? Is this sexy?
Yes.
What do you think of her belly?
Very nice.
Yeah. Why don't you kiss her belly?
Ooh, very nice belly.
Belly kiss.
Yeah.
I just want to rip this shirt open.
Go ahead.
Should I?
Just go nuts, yeah.
Go ahead.
Enjoy.
Can I just rip it open?
Yeah, go nuts. If you can't handle it, you can't handle. Oh, jeez. Wow. Totally exposed now. Melissa, thank you. Explain.
I guess. Sexy Hulk just, Hogan.
Got it almost.
Liz ripped the shirt right off Crazy Claire, and now we see her beautiful breasts.
All right, why don't we lift her up there on top so they can have a nice little kiss from that vantage point. It's just a way of saying we did it. We conquered.
Everyone's very proud of you guys.
Yeah.
Thank you.
This is the best birthday ever.
Mm-hmm. By the way, we have cake, too. We're having cake later in the other room. Listen to the girls.
Wow, this is really hot, too. Because you have the one laying down, and then you have the one standing. It's really sexy. And you have Claire with her hair like Princess Leia. So you kind of...
Right.
That's pretty sexy.
We might have to sign Melissa before she becomes competition for us.
Right, yeah.
Go ahead. I'm not going anywhere, Ronnie. Wow, they really like each other now.
It's still going on.
They were a little timid before, but now I see as the game progressed, they're happy.
I love crazy girls. Nothing better.
And the gallery seems to approve.
Hey, Justin. Justin, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, buddy. Justin.
What's going on, guys?
Hey, man.
Yo, I got to say, dude, this has got to be some of the hottest radio I have ever heard.
You know, here's the really sweet thing about it. It's like really three girl next doors. None of them is a dancer or a pro.
From the website.
Right, when she was in here before. Right, thanks.
Yeah.
And she is, man, Fuzzy.
Gorgeous. Thanks, guys.
She's the birthday girl.
I might go home looking for Colleen Poole tonight.
I'm wearing my birthday suit on.
Yes.
On your birthday.
She's not taking. Let's have another little kiss for you guys. Just enjoy. Just enjoy each other. A little kiss.
Another little kiss?
Yeah. Are you guys really feel like you're heading it off?
I think so.
Yeah, this could turn into something long term. I really do.
Just past tonight.
It's definitely.
And then one day you'll tell your adopted children about us.
Well, you'll never guess how we met.
I'm very attracted to her, so.
Get Grandma the knives and we'll tell you how we met.
Hey, Dan, you're on Run of Fez.
Hi, Dan.
Hey, how you guys doing?
Yeah,
better.
Cool. You guys are great. I love your show.
Thanks, buddy.
I just wanted to say that, Melissa, you're making me use my junk as an antenna, and I want to know if you want to go out.
Oh.
That was beautiful.
Justin, that's really hot.
You want to go out with antenna junk?
I have never.
Antenna junk. I'm going right to my car.
All right. I ain't classy enough to actually say to a girl, "You're so hot. You're making me use my junk to pick up a radio show."
That's class there, Ronnie.
Yeah.
Well, the visual is not that impressive. A thin antenna, you know.
I was thinking, well, our antenna's on top of the Empire State Building.
Sure.
So that's where, you know, when Claire does these little moans, that's where it flies off, Fezzy. Yeah. Right off the Empire State Building.
For everyone to enjoy.
Yeah. Mike, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, Mike.
Hey, Run of Fez. This is the best radio ever.
Oh, thank you very much.
And even though today ONA sucked in the lesbian couch, I know.
Well, they had
they were ugly, weren't they?
Yeah, and this can happen to you. That happens sometimes. And what we really planned on doing was, because you can't trust people, we were going to make Liz come by here because we know you. And if she was really unattractive, we didn't want you going, "Wah!" You know, just crazy, running down the street, jabbing at people in your boxer shorts.
Straight jacket, dragging behind you, you're just screaming. This worked out really well, better than we could hope.
Yeah, better than we can hope. And I honestly think something's coming out. You know, maybe what we can do is send you guys out on a date, too.
That would be nice. Yeah.
But only if you're dressed this way.
Where would we go? Hard Rock Cafe?
No. Somewhere nice.
Send us to a strip club.
Not that a Hard Rock isn't nice. But what I'm trying to say is not
somewhere nice to not wear clothes
for the lesbian clientele.
For the lesbian in you.
There are lesbians.
Who do we love more than Hard Rock Johnny?
Nobody.
I've been in the Hard Rock Cafe.
It's great.
It is. It was wonderful. The food was great.
But she's teasing because she said, what are you going to do, walk us across the street? No, we want to send you nice, somewhere nice, Lesbo Island.
Well, you can send us to a lesbian strip club.
Yeah, that'd be fun.
Is there such a place?
There are.
In heaven? I think that's what they tell the terrorists when they die. You're going to a lesbian strip club. What do you care?
877-692-1027.
Julio, you're on Ron and Fez.
Guys, I tell you.
Hey,
you
Julio.
Guys better, you guys better keep a lock on Melissa because when ONA hear the show, they're going to come and they're going to take her from you.
You know, they're already after Melissa. Opie was begging to trade Mario Cantone, and of course Fezzi's like, the whole thing. And I go, no, don't listen.
No, he doesn't even know Fezzi exists, so forget that.
Right, Julio.
You gotta keep Melissa. Handcuffs or something.
Melissa's wonderful.
Know. It was weird because Opie was insistent on getting Sweet Melissa, and I think we were gonna get Mario Cantone, Kimmy Gibbler, and an intern to be named later.
Who wants Kimmy Gibbler?
Stinky.
Well, that. Maybe she can sing us some opera tonight.
Oh, that'd be fun.
She's half drunk and she's. I took opera for 8 years. I could have been a star. Everybody's Joe Poo now.
Yeah, I was about to say, everybody's
except
got Joe Poo.
Except for Joe Poo.
Right, go ahead and say something funny, Joe.
Don't put me on. What's on your list next?
Or you want to sing another funny song? Alright, let's hear him.
That's so hot.
That is exactly you.
Nailed it.
I feel useless. Liz is so hot. Claire has brought knives. It's so hot, hot, hot.
You can't even listen to it.
Sweet Melissa. Will she kiss her? It's so hot.
That was a good line. The first
you stink. When will they finally get to it? We can't wait.
I am not a retard.
I can't do this.
How'd y'all like to suck my ass?
Let's open the window to that faces Bayonne.
Yeah.
And see what they're saying. Let's open that window.
Let's see what the people of Bayonne think.
You suck.
Close that Bayonne window.
Yeah. All right, Orville wants to fill us in on a nice date. Hey, Orville, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Ron and Fez.
Hey, Orville.
Hey, I'm grooving on this soft, sensual Melissa. I love her voice.
Everybody loves her.
Tell her, please, dear God, don't shut up. She's got to keep talking.
All right, I'll tell you what, Orville. We'll do. You say you know a lesbian bar?
Yeah, I've heard of one called the Meow Mix out on Houston Street.
Oh, I've heard of it, too.
And they have dancers there?
I think so.
They have everything there. Trump,
you know, believe me when I tell you.
Like themselves,
if you two youngsters go walking in there, they will swarm you. Yeah.
They can take Crazy Clair with her and their big knives. I'm sure she can hold them off.
All right, Orville, I'll tell you what we're going to give you since you're a fan of Melissa. She'll say anything, just one line, anything you want.
I like it when she was describing the way... Liz was cutting the shirt off.
All right, but you got to say something specific, and then she'll say it for you, okay?
Oh, I like, the way she said, kiss me. Yeah. The way she said, she was saying, kiss me.
Kiss me.
Thank you.
All right, there you go.
That easy. Another satisfied customer.
Seriously, if we could open up a business like that, Fezzi.
She'd be great at phone sex.
Yeah, wouldn't she?
Totally.
Yeah, right, like she doesn't already. You better not have a phone sex line, dude.
I don't have a phone sex
line. I'm sure she's done it before, though.
I called, and it was the one night that she wasn't there. Yeah, what can I do for you, big boy? It's Colleen. What's your pleasure? Name your poison. Colleen Pooh. I'm as hot as August in Bayonne. Yeah,
that's hot.
My drawers are sticking to my ass. How you doing?
Speaking of which, don't I get to cut Joe Poo's clothes off now?
Yeah, we're going to do that.
Nice.
Also,
just the nudity. Pants.
All right, we'll grab our song, too, for that. We'll bring that in. Also, Fezzi, we got in a little bit, we're going to give out JetBlue tickets.
JetBlue, pair of round-trip tickets to anywhere JetBlue Airways flies in the continental U.S. Tickets courtesy of JetBlue. They're our pals. JetBlue, it's not the only way to fly, but it should be.
Yeah.
So we'll have a competition to get a pair of round-trip JetBlue Airways tickets.
Now, all you girls are staying with us tonight, right?
Yeah, definitely. Slumber party.
Oh, would that be the funnest thing?
That sounds like a great idea.
And then, look, I'll tell you what I'll do. You know, you'll be giggling, and I'll just turn the lights on. What's going on with you girls up here? It's your Uncle Joe Poo. You know I gotta deliver pizzas tomorrow. You know I don't do that anymore. I'm Colleen. Why wasn't I invited to this slumber party? I wear a sleeping bag as pajamas.
Leave the room, Colleen, or I'll slap the slippers off you.
When's the last time you delivered a pizza, Joe?
2 weeks ago.
All right. So that's in your past.
That's
so Jackie O for me.
Oh, because it's over?
Yeah.
Jackie over.
Hey, I'm Matt. Matt, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Matt.
Yeah, how you doing?
Hey, buddy.
Ron, Fez.
Yeah.
Melissa, Claire, all of you are just so beautiful. It's amazing.
Hi.
Thanks, man.
It's like great.
Ron radio. Is really beautiful.
You Thank
right.
you very much.
I think the reef has moved a little closer to the island.
Yeah, you know what? It's just a one-time-only show.
Sure.
You know, we have... really, these are just our friends now, Fuzzy. These are our hot chicks.
Right.
And
this isn't like a made... show. They're just dropping by.
We're in the stable, right?
Yeah, I feel like we made a new friend tonight.
Yes. Right. We got so lucky.
And you know, you'll...
I got lucky for being able to come in.
And you'll come partying with us now.
Yeah, hell yeah.
I want to do, you know, all of you girls and me in the back of a limo one night. I'm just doing lines off your ass and telling you stories of the old days.
That is nice when you do lines off people.
And we'll probably, you know, you'll probably all participate in the puke contest on Friday.
You've done that too, Colin?
Yeah. Yeah.
You know,
God grant me the serenity things I cannot shame.
That I cannot cut through.
You know what my line, my thing is, I used to say, yeah, well, the next line's coming off of here, honey, so it's up to you.
Now it turns dark.
Uh-oh, there's the birthday song.
What does that mean?
Oh, my God.
It means it's birthday cake.
Oh, wow.
Watch the candles. You burn your nips.
They even put my name on it.
They put your name on it. Read it.
I didn't even get a birthday.
Happy birthday, crazy.
Thanks, guys.
Happy birthday, crazy. And then, look, they drew a knife in it. And then Now, we sent Joe over to get the cake. What happened there, Joe?
The lady's like, I can't draw a knife like it was something insane for her to see. All right, joke number three, taking care of.
Yes, and it's only 9:38.
Can you imagine if Fez and I only did three jokes a night?
Hey, I'm just riding your coattail.
You got your 9 o'clock joke done. You got one at 10, and you're all finished for the night.
Well, boys... It looks like Joe Poo's work is over. I got a knock-knock joke for 10:15. Then I'll probably head on out of here.
Taking the path back to Jersey.
It's 23 Skidoo. Bayonne, here I come. I'm taking a powder, fellas. Back to Bayonne to do the Hucklebuck.
So I make a wish now, right?
Yeah, make a wish.
Okay.
And then leap
Making
on
Making a wish.
Yeah.
Okay.
What do you got, emphysema?
Yeah, I smoke a lot.
Yeah.
I can't blow out 4 candles.
All right,
I got 3, though.
Let's do another kiss, and then we will head into spots, Fuzzy.
So am I cutting the cake?
Yeah. Cut the cake.
Of course.
You're going to cut the cake. You come back, we'll cut Joe Poo, we'll do it all.
Yeah, we'll do it all. Also, we're giving away some JetBlue tickets in just a little bit. Don't miss it. It's the Ron and Fez Show.
WNEW. The last ain't bad either. We're Ron and Fez. Birthday party going on for Crazy Claire. She got her clothes cut off by her new friend Liz. Liz first got her clothes cut off by Crazy Claire. The knives are flying tonight. And we just had cake. How could it be any better? Sweet Melissa's here in the studio with us.
Hiya.
Who's just so adorable, Fez.
And, of course, Joe Poo is here tonight as well.
Hello.
Hey.
Everyone runs into the Poo boy.
Ron and Fez. Paranoid's outside demanding on the camera. Where the hell is it?
You don't know how bad I need it.
That's cute. All right, here's the real way she said it to kill this. Hold on, let me find it here.
Oh, you don't know how bad I need it.
We move these things around so that Rory Hampton's can put this on.
You won't get me, Sue. I'll get you.
How's that helping?
It adds to the ambiance.
Yeah, it really does.
Stella, come tonight. Your chance to win round-trip airfare, a pair of tickets on JetBlue Airways. Also, here's another way you can pick up a set of JetBlue Airways tickets. Play the football pool at ronfez.net. Winner of the football pool this week receives round-trip tickets, a pair of them, anywhere JetBlue flies in the continental U.S.
All right, so we're going to play JetBlue's Clues for a pair of tickets. You can fly anywhere in the country, Fez, anywhere.
Anywhere JetBlue goes.
Yeah, so they go to places like L.A., Florida, Oakland,
Seattle, Denver, New Orleans, just about anywhere in Florida.
Yeah.
You can head upstate if you need to.
Any place you've ever really wanted to go before, but you haven't.
Right.
How about for you? Where's one place you've always wanted to go but haven't gone yet?
I would probably say the Los Angeles.
No, really?
Yeah, because I've never made it. I made it to Vegas.
Yeah.
But I would really like to actually...
Put your foot in the other ocean?
Right, yeah.
Yeah, that's always a thing with kids, though.
Yeah, and not a Hollywood thing or anything. I just really want to see that Pacific Ocean. I hear it's huge.
But from the beach, it looks exactly like the Atlantic.
Sure.
Except for the water is in the parking lot. I go, I would constantly be diving the wrong way if I lived here. It's frightening.
How does the water get on this side?
Where's some place you really want to go?
Seattle,
yeah. One place I've always wanted to go, Fezzy, and have never been, is down Melissa's top.
Oh, really? Yeah.
I don't know when I'll get there.
I'm checking the list of destinations.
Just someday I want to get there. I don't know when. You know, you just, it's a pipe dream. All right, let's just check around. Joe Poo, what about for you?
San Diego.
Really? Sand Dog?
Yeah.
Sailor Bars?
Just because it's the farthest place from Bayonne.
Please.
And you're not too far away from TJ.
Yeah. The farthest place from Bayonne is a clean bathroom.
Exact opposite.
All right. All right, Melissa. Crazy Claire, where would you really like to go?
Vegas,
baby?
Yeah.
Vegas, baby.
That's our hangout.
I want to see Showgirls and all the neon.
We can rent you that.
Yeah. I want to pretend like I'm in Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas.
Well, you live that way anyway. That's how she sees the world.
I know. I really want to do it there.
Yeah, it's fun. Mm-hmm. Well, we have, as a matter of fact. When we go to Vegas, we don't sleep for 5-6 days, and we get that whole weird thing going, and we always... have a real paranoid feeling when we're waiting for the plane to leave.
It's very nice when you finally get to that point, you realize you're in the artificial lights of a casino that many days in a row, and wait a minute, nighttime? Daytime.
Right.
Can't tell. Cannot tell unless you went outside. And even then, you're not going to believe your eyes, so.
All right, let's check with our new buddy Liz. Liz, where do you want to go?
I'd love to go to Arizona.
Really?
Yeah.
Now, I love Arizona, too.
Yeah.
Any place in particular there?
Scottsdale.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I was in Sedona. Very, very, very cool place. And there are, like, all these, Indian, you know, things going, like, these New Age things, you know, we were hanging out there. And I just started yelling, Indians, and I'm shooting.
Right.
And apparently this is all cleared up now.
Oh, well, I didn't know.
No.
I'm there.
And I just screamed, Indians!
Right.
They're like, no, that's like a medicine man.
You're trying to protect people.
Yeah.
I don't know.
So you got to be real careful.
Right.
Yeah.
I'll keep that in mind.
Yeah. All right, let's just check with the Hawk. And then, you know, maybe we'll play this game, Fuzzy.
I know he's going to say Jamaica Queens.
Yeah, where do you want to go, Hawk? You've never been off the island of Queens.
No, I want to check out New Orleans.
New
Orleans, baby.
Nice. Yeah. Now, did you like that food they brought us that night?
I wasn't here that night.
No, you weren't?
You missed it when the gumbo crew came in.
But I like gumbo.
Yeah, we went crazy on it.
We had food. So much.
Yeah. Now I'm starving just thinking about it.
And jambalaya.
Hey, do me a favor, Joe Poo. When you get another cake, make it even sweeter so we all die.
Yeah.
I got it in Bayonne.
I'd rather eat your mom's krasikis.
That's not it.
Haven't you?
Mom made them with love. That's it. Good night. Four jokes.
4 hours.
That sounds dirty. You'd rather eat his mom's krishikis.
Like, you think?
Like the word could be something else.
Like what? What could it be?
It's Polish for cookies.
Yes. So you'd rather eat Joe's mom's than eat this cake.
And you think you and Liz are going to be going out?
Sure, yeah. If she wants to.
Do you guys live close? Did you figure out?
No, not really.
Where do you live?
I live in Connecticut.
Oh.
Yeah.
There's
it's
a ferry,
close to anything.
Though.
Oh, that's Fez. That's just Fez.
No, I don't like living in Connecticut. But.
Now, where do you want to live? Vegas.
Vegas, baby.
Manhattan.
I hope you get my ass to Vegas one day. So far, I'm going to Atlantic City with $17. And my grandmother.
Only $2.
Like Bayonne, except cleaner.
Yeah. Hey, remember your big date with Joe Poo when he had $2?
That was so awful, wasn't it, Joe? Come on. That
yeah,
was
wow. Sweet Melissa never says anything about anybody.
Oh, no. It was just so bad. We're like, oh, where are we going to go? Do you want to eat? He just wanted to watch me eat. That's really fun.
I was just going to have some hot water and ketchup. I call it made of soup. Bayonne stew. Hot water and ketchup.
I feel like the paper boy from Better Off Dead.
I only got $2.
Wow, an extra joke for us tonight.
Number six.
Oh, hey, that's overtime.
You're overtime.
That's time and a half, guys.
It really is. Now, Claire, maybe you can help Joe Poo out a little bit. You're good with a knife, right?
Yeah, it looks like he needs his clothes cut off.
He needs his clothes cut off, definitely. And he also needs his foot worked on.
Cut off?
Well, there's a big...
Please don't tell me there's, like, calluses or something in their cords. Wow.
You're going to have to see it to believe it.
All right, let's get him up there and pull your shoes off, Joe.
All right.
We'll start with your shoes. Get him up on the console.
If I ever had a foot fetish, I would probably retract that.
Now, you don't have a foot fetish to go with everything else.
No.
My foot's not very erotic.
Get like the music.
Look at those.
Oh, my God. So white.
Now, let's see that. Can you swing it this way?
There's a lot of...
portable.
There's a lot of lint on it.
Oh, my gosh. What a... That is actually... That callus is the shape of the state of New York. On his foot.
It's a souvenir.
Those feet are just filthy, too, besides the callus.
They're black socks. What do you have, lint-free specials?
Number seven. No way. Nobody laughed at that.
No one did.
They're laughing at home.
You lost the joke on that.
All right, get up on the console.
So we cross
Claire.
Seven. So I'm cutting his foot off, right?
No, you're not.
Just the callus.
As much as you can.
Do you think you could dig any of that callus off?
Oh, God. Where I don't even know where I'm looking.
Oh, God.
I don't know.
Look at that thing, sweet Melissa.
What color is it?
It's yellow.
It's a greenish yellow.
I don't think I want to taint my knife by touching it.
Why did you let it get so big?
Huh?
Why did you let it get so big?
I just one day.
Wait a minute, that could be her new thing. Why did you let it get so big?
Even when talking about podiatry problems.
Say it again. As hot as you can. Ready? Go ahead.
Why did you let it get so big?
You want to see it? I only got $2.
Oh, God. She's down. Melissa's down.
Oh, no.
She did a fez fall to the floor.
Joe, have you ever heard of a pumice stone or excavation?
I got one right here.
Would
that's
you mind
a cinder block.
Would you mind scraping that across it?
Are you kidding me?
I rinsed it off in the water for
him. I'll tell you what. You
it's
do
my
that,
birthday.
You do that for him, and then you can cut his clothes off.
I don't.
Get the cake knife out of here, you maniac.
You know what? Cutting his clothes off is really not that important.
All right, now.
And just cut his clothes off and get it over with.
Girls that do nothing but slice each other are grossed out by you.
How about we put a little cake on my foot and she lifts it off?
I got a lot of lint in there.
A starving Afghan mule would not lick anything off that foot.
That thing is sick.
How about an Afghan
dog? You know
what?
It's spreading.
Yeah, because it's not just one spot,
it's not
is
just
it?
The heel. It's kind of all over. Kind of like island.
Yeah, that's a fungus. That's what fungus does. It spreads, doctor.
I just scraped some fungus. Just take it and just gently scrape the fungus off his foot.
I'm terrified.
All right, how about we just pretend I do it?
No! Oh, you Penny Allen?
Use Al's knife if you don't want to use your own.
Wait, I'm scraping the fungi.
Yeah, be careful, I do have blood.
No! Wait!
It's, I can't even cut through it so hard.
Oh,
that?
God, listen to that thing.
Oh, gross. It sounds like I'm sharpening my knife, but instead I'm rubbing it against your blood.
Are you getting any on the knife?
It's turning white now. It's not yellow anymore, now it's white.
You cleaned it.
Yeah, I think the knife is actually getting sharpened through this hole.
Oh, his foot is now pumice.
Can you even feel that, Joe?
No, not a thing. Give it a little stab. No, I'm only kidding, really. Just see how much you can feel.
No, don't stab it.
What do you think is... All right, now, Melissa, you know biology, right?
Yes,
what
sir.
Has he done?
He has a fungus that he's let spread way too far. Like,
what should he do? Is he going to lose the foot?
Oh, there's powder all over the
knife.
Oh, my God. I can't touch it anymore. We're done.
All right, you're done with that part.
You guys want to see it?
No.
Let's see it.
It looks like dandruff.
Hand it over.
Chase Al with it.
Yeah,
stab Al with that knife.
I knocked it a lot off when I threw it.
Oh, that's disgusting.
Give it a little taste. $10 is to lick it, Fez. $10.
Only 10?
Yes.
I'll give you 5, so it's 15.
I'll give you $2. That's your 2. You need that. That's your 1. Your bankroll. Oh,
oh, God.
You smelled it.
That knife stinks so bad.
Oh, God. Really?
Oh, God.
Is it on the other foot, too?
We throw it, Al.
We can't possibly cut cake with that knife anymore.
Yes, it smells like feet. That's where it came from.
Yes, it's powdered feet.
A deep statement from
Elvis. This is a wheel. This is fire. Nice going, cave boy. Yeah, make fun of him. Fungus foot. This is what happens when you swim in the public pools in Bayonne.
Melissa almost just threw up. She's disgusted.
It's bad, isn't it, Melissa?
They look like sort of like plantar warts, but not
at
all. And they're all over.
It's like planter's nuts.
That's what he's got in his pants. Playing his nuts.
Got the,
Are you still working on it, Claire?
I'm not touching it.
Yeah. Your head's going to be shaped like Mr. Peanut by the time you're done.
All you need is a monocle and a cane.
Here, I'll give him a little stab.
Hey, look at the way Joe's sitting there. Does he not look 4 years old with his foot out?
Yeah.
There we go.
All right, now you're working on it.
Make it all better.
Just keep scraping. You got all night.
All right, now you know science, you know biology, Melissa.
Yes.
Is the best thing we could do for his foot is to just keep slicing it with knives?
I would just cut it off.
Or are we just spreading it?
Yeah, just cut it off, get it over with.
What if we take off a toenail? I clipped him for the show.
Thank you.
No, that's sensitive. That's good looking. Good
those toenails. We can't tell the difference anymore.
Those toenails are as thick as they are long.
How did everybody find out about this? You just like took your sock off one day and were like, check this out.
I whipped it out one night.
Good impression.
Mind if I use that one?
Check this out.
All right, let's take 4 contestants, Fuzzy.
Okay.
Give away the JetBlue's...
Instead of the thing, you should just have him be able to scrape off Joe's...
No, I can't. We'll come back to that later. But when we do come back, we'll take 4 contestants. And Fez will explain to you how you can win a trip anywhere in the continental U.S. thanks to our good friends at JetBlue.
That's right. JetBlue tickets. We'll take 4 contestants. They'll compete against each other playing JetBlue's Clues. What we'll do is we'll describe the contents... of a celebrity. God, you're so gross, Joe Poo.
He's got no shame.
I look over and Melissa has just looked down at the floor nervously. Like, I've just seen the worst thing anybody could ever witness.
It's like looking at war atrocities, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It's war crimes.
All right. JetBlue's Clues.
Oh, my God.
We're going to describe the contents of a celebrity suitcase. You have to tell us, clue by clue, who the celebrity is. We'll have 4 people competing to see who can guess the celebrity first. The first out of the 4 to guess 3 celebrities gets the trip.
Nothing could seem more confusing.
I know. Doesn't
this.
Seem awful. It seemed good at dinner.
All right, give me an example how it would work. You don't have to use one of yours. You think one, and I'll try and guess. Okay.
Okay.
Give me some JetBlue's clues. You found some luggage, did you, Fez?
Yes,
I did.
It
hasn't been picked up yet by the baggage handlers?
Right. Maybe we can tell who it belongs to.
Okay.
By checking inside it.
All right. What do we got inside there?
Oh, let's see, Ronnie. We have a WWF title belt.
Is it Hulk Hogan?
No, uh-uh.
What else?
Let's see. There's some Olympic gold medals in there.
Oh, is it Kurt Angle?
Yes, it is.
All right, now, if I did that, I'm on my way.
Then you've got one, and you'd have to get two more to win the trip.
Wow, that seems hard.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah, I don't want
to. It's rough, but it's a great prize.
Yeah, let's just leave it up to the contestants to play. When we get back, we'll pick out four to play JetBlue's Clues.
877-692-1027.
We're on a Fez.
WNEW. Round trip airfare for two on JetBlue on the line. We're Ron and Fez.
All right, we're going to take four people, Fezzy, just at random here.
Okay.
And let them play. And what happens is they'll have to yell their name out first.
Okay. Yeah, if they can answer the question, of course, it's JetBlue's Clues presents...
It's time for Whose Luggage Is It?
Does that even make sense?
They have to tell us whose luggage it belongs to by looking through it. We'll give them the clues. Whoever knows it first out of the four, yell out their own name. We'll get them all on the line and we'll explain it again.
Over and over. Here's Rich from line 8. Rich, how you doing, buddy?
All right, boys. How you doing tonight?
Rich, where you from?
Staten Island.
Staten Island. Congratulations.
Represent. Thank you.
He's here to represent Shaolin, Fezzy. Just like Wu-Tang. Wu-Tang all the way.
And the Wu-Tang sword style.
And the Wu-Tang what?
The Wu-Tang sword style.
I didn't know that one. What happens there is that they think they're ninjas, don't they?
Wow.
Rich, if you won this contest, where would you go?
Visit my grandkids in Florida.
In Florida. What town are they in?
Inverness. Inverness.
Inverness. Oh, I know that.
Yeah.
A lot of golfing there.
A lot of old people there, too.
Mm-hmm.
From Staten Island.
Shaolin. All right, here's Caroline. Caroline, you're on our... Wait, I just lost him.
Hey, guys.
All right, hold on. Hey, make sure I get him back, okay, Billy? Caroline, you're on Ron and Fez.
Good evening.
Yeah.
Hi, Caroline. Where would you fly if you could?
I would love to go to San Francisco because I've never been there.
You know, I was just out there this summer. Fantastic.
Oh,
matter of fact, I left my heart there. If you get a chance.
Really?
Yeah.
San
Francisco. Looks like I'll
still
bring
beating.
It back for you.
Still beating. Okay. All right. We got Caroline. She wants to go to San Francisco. Rich, I got him back. You want to go to Inverness, which is just beautiful this time of year.
Gorgeous place in Florida.
And, let's go, Jimmy. Jimmy, you're on Ron and Fez. Hey, Jimmy.
Hey, what's up?
How are you, my friend?
Very good, very good.
Jimmy, where are you calling from?
Hackensack.
Hackensack. And if you won this contest, where would you be going?
Ooh, Cabo San Lucas, Dallas, Texas, Oahu, Baja, California, Pittsburgh, Indiana, New Orleans.
You just want a party. You want to get out of town.
And there's nothing more beautiful this time of year than Pittsburgh, Indiana.
You know that place is getting bigger all the time.
Oh, yeah.
And we'll go one more. Here is Vanessa on line 9, Fuzzy.
Hi, Vanessa.
Vanessa, hi. Where are you calling from?
Calling from Jersey.
And if you won this contest, where would you be going, Vanessa?
Go to Disney World.
Going to Disney World, Fezzy.
Okay, Orlando, Florida, one of JetBlue's destinations.
Just like Schilling and Johnson, she's going to Disney World.
All right.
Now remember, when you want to answer, you yell out your name.
Okay.
Now here's the other bad thing, though. If you yell out your name and it's a wrong answer, you have to sit out that round.
Right.
And first person to win three rounds is on their way with the JetBlue's situation. Hey, is this exciting, Melissa?
This is awesome.
Yeah, right. She's so nice to us.
And I'll tell you what, Joe Poo, you listen very closely. If it's close on whose name gets yelled out, you're the final judge on who gets the answer.
Let's get it on. All right, so make sure you pay attention, Joe, because this is important.
Okay.
All right. It is for a trip on JetBlue.
a pair of round-trip tickets anywhere JetBlue flies in the continental U.S. All right, here's how it's going to work. We're going to name some items we found in a suitcase. After we list each item, you can yell in if you know who those items belong to, all right?
Got it.
Everyone understand?
Yep.
Any questions at all before we start?
Yep. We have to wait until you say everything, or can we just jump in?
Jump in, but if you're wrong, then you're out for that round, okay? And you got to win three rounds.
Okay?
Go for it.
Something in the suitcase.
All right, now make sure you yell your name out so then nobody else can answer on that one but you, okay?
Okay.
Right, Fez, let's start it off.
All right, here's the first round. The first item we found was a picture of JFK Jr.
Is it my grandmother?
All right, we can't play games during the big important...
Okay, I'm going to have to turn off the mic.
I'm sorry.
All right, now, did you say Jim? Did you yell your name?
Daryl Hannah
is correct.
Wow. Wow, that could
have
been...
How many more I got to get?
You got to get two more. All right, the other clues in that suitcase were a Jackson Brown album, a fake finger, and a mermaid costume.
I should get 2 points for that.
Daryl Hannah. Should he get 2 points, Fez?
No, just one.
All right, so I guess it's 2-0. Jim is leading?
1-0.
All right. 1-0. All right, everybody. Yikes. Nobody wants to change the rules, Jim. All right, let's go again, Fez. And please, you got to be careful.
I'm sorry.
During this, we could be sued.
Okay. Here's the next round. Tell us what celebrity we're looking in their luggage. We found a toupee. A Florida State University football jersey.
All right, so that's toupee and Florida State football jersey. Nobody yet?
No.
All right, go ahead, Fezzy.
A CB radio. Anyone?
No.
All right, and finally, a little black book with 4 stars next to Dinah Shores and Judy...
Rich.
Rich.
Burt Reynolds.
Burt Reynolds is correct. All right, what's the score now, Joe Poo?
Rich has one and Jim has one.
Okay. Whoever gets to 3 first wins. Here is the next JetBlue's clues. An NBC coffee mug. A piece of the Berlin Wall from the night it went down.
All right, that's an NBC coffee mug and a piece of the Berlin Wall the night it went down. Nobody yet, right? All right, Fezzy.
Next thing we found, a copy of the book, The Greatest Generation.
Caroline.
Who got that one, Caroline?
Caroline.
All right, Caroline.
It's Peter Jennings.
Wrong. Rich.
Sorry.
Dan Rabba.
Wrong.
Sorry.
All right, so only Jimmy and Vanessa are remaining in this round.
And the final clue.
Well, hold on, see if either one of them wants to take a guess before we get the final clue.
Give me the last clue.
All right, go over the first 3 clues first, Fez.
An NBC coffee mug. A piece of the Berlin Wall from the night it went down. A copy of the book, The Greatest Generation.
Okay, only Jimmy and Vanessa are in this. Let's go to the last clue.
The last clue is Cipro.
Jimmy. David Letterman.
No, sorry.
Sorry.
Vanessa, you get to take a guess.
I have no idea.
Fezzy?
I have no idea.
All right.
That luggage belonged to Tom Brokaw.
I can't believe I blew it.
Oh my God.
Works at NBC, was the only reporter the night the wall went down in Berlin, wrote the book, The Greatest Generation, and took Cipro for anthrax.
All right. So what's the score, Joe Poo?
Jim with 1, Rich with 1, and the other loses with nothing.
All right, don't judge. We'll just say that they each have
one.
Get the score. All right, you ready for your next JetBlue's clues?
I'm so excited I could cut some of his clothes off.
Okay, here's the next one. A Texas flag. A bicycle.
Jim,
give it a shot.
Pee Wee Herman or Paul Rubens.
Sorry.
All right, you're out now, Jim. Only Rich, Vanessa, and Caroline. Give them the clues again, Fez.
All right, those first 2 clues, a Texas flag and a bicycle.
All right, keep it going, Fez.
Next clue, a yellow jacket.
Caroline.
Caroline, go ahead.
Lance Armstrong?
Lance Armstrong is correct.
Woohoo!
All right, Caroline on the board now.
The final clue was going to be a testicle.
Now, Jimmy, that was a very nice try. I didn't even think of Pee Wee.
Yeah, that's good. That's why sometimes you need all the clues.
Oh, Jimmy, there's no basement at the Alamo.
That story.
I thought for sure there was. All right, Joe Poo, what's the score?
Jim, Rich, and Carolyn all tied up with one.
All right, and nothing for Vanessa. Now, remember, as soon as you get to three, you solve three, you're on your way anywhere in the continental United States a JetBlue flies to.
All right, here's the next round. The clues begin with an Oscar. All right. Business card from a tattoo artist.
Rich.
Rich.
All right. Angela Jolie.
That is correct.
Ooh. Rich took a shot and got it, Fuzzy.
That could have been anybody.
Yeah, it could have been.
The final two clues. The final two clues were going to be vial of blood on a necklace and naked pictures of her brother.
Don't we all have those?
They're having fun.
What's the score, Joe Poo?
Rich with two, Jim with one, and Carolyn with one.
All right.
And what wins again?
Three.
You got to win three. So who's got two?
Rich.
Rich? Rich, you are one away, my friend.
Sweat.
Okay. Here we go. A modeling portfolio. No guesses.
No.
An engagement ring. Nothing. Beatles records. No one. And the final clue, a fake leg.
Crap.
Jim.
Jim.
Paul McCartney's new wife.
What's her name?
I don't know that.
Gotta know her name. Oh, crap.
Mrs. McCartney. It is her, though.
Mrs. McCartney.
Oh, well, she's not married yet.
No, it's fiancé. That's why it's only an engagement ring.
Wife-to-be. She's gonna be it.
Crap. We all knew it, but nobody knows her name.
All right, what's the answer, Fez?
The answer, of course, is Heather Mills.
Yep, that's it. Heather Mills.
Yeah.
That's what he said.
They walk alike, they talk alike.
She never comes to Bayonne.
All right, ready for the next round? No one picks up a point there.
Now, remember, Rich is only needs one more to win it all.
All right, here is the next one. Hair bleach. Court papers from divorce and assault charges.
Rich.
Rich, what do you got?
Pamela Lee.
Sorry. Even though that one sounds good, all right, you are out of this round, Rich. Fezzy, what are the clues so far?
The clues so far, Ronnie, in this piece of luggage, hair bleach and court papers from divorce and assault charges. The next clue is a torn-up Mother's Day card. Anyone?
No.
No.
Yes.
And the final clue, the final JetBlue's clue.
Remember to yell your name, by the way.
Yep.
A fan letter signed Stan.
Caroline.
Caroline, I heard.
Caroline.
Is it Anna Nicole Smith?
No.
No.
Sorry.
Vanessa.
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 Yeah.
Eminem.
Eminem is correct.
Oh, nice.
Oh, my God. Nice. It's about time. I'm not an idiot.
Yeah. We'll see.
Yeah.
All right, Joe Poo, what's the score now?
Jim, Carolyn, and Vanessa with one, Rich with two.
Okay, here we go. The next clue is hair beads. No one. The following clue, a letter of apology from Sid Rosenberg. No one.
Vanessa.
Vanessa, what do you got?
Serena Williams?
Sorry. Sorry. Not Serena Williams.
Rich.
Rich for the win.
Venus Williams.
It is Venus Williams.
Yeah, boy.
If you would have listened to all the clues, they would have been hair beads, letter of apology from Sid Rosenberg, tennis racket, and 2001 U.S. Open's Women's Single Championship Trophy, which Venus has, Serena does not.
All right. Thank you very much, Caroline.
Thank you, guys.
We'll see you later. Vanessa, thank you very much.
Thanks, guys.
Bye-bye. Thanks, you. Jimmy?
Hey, who's going to be on the show tomorrow, Ronald?
probably two girls slicing each other and Melissa.
Right.
And Rich, you are the winner, buddy. Way to go.
Excellent. Thank you.
Rich, you are heading to Florida, right?
That should be accurate. I believe so.
You can fly into Tampa on that, right, Fez?
Yep, you certainly will.
Out of JFK, right?
Yeah. Right, yep.
You can head out of JFK to Tampa?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
On JetBlue Airways. It's not the only way to fly, but it should be. Check them out online at JetBlue.com or 1-800-JETBLUE.
Rich, how old are the grandchildren?
5 and 1.
Oh, that's terrific.
That's going to be nice for you.
Yeah. Yes, it will.
All right, hold on, my friend. And,
thank you, guys.
Nice work.
Al will bore you, and then somehow at the end you should find out how to work all this out. But there you go, Fezzy.
All right.
Nice little game tonight.
That was fun. Thanks. I got tense at the end.
Thanks to Fez and Jim for that, working on it together. That was an exciting one to play it.
That's cool.
Let me check with Melissa to make sure. Melissa, did you like it?
I loved it. Way to go, Rich.
Now, is there
would you have won?
Yeah.
No.
Now, tell me the truth, Melissa. Is there anything on this show that you ever have not liked? Tell the truth.
I don't
want
to say
it. I want you to say it. I want you to say one mean thing, because it sounds like all she does is compliment us and like everything.
Okay. Well, you did this one thing called confession.
Yeah.
I hated it. It was really mean. You had these guys call up, and they're, like, victimizing their, like, relatives in bed. You don't remember it.
Oh, that was funny.
And this guy was like, yeah, I was sleeping next to my cousin, and I rubbed one out. And, God. It was awful.
Right.
I remember that.
What about
that?
The guy who used to wake up his wife? That was great.
Oh, wacky wake-up wife guy.
Yeah,
he was great.
Ever.
But it's got to be 2 o'clock in the morning for that.
Right, yeah. You wake her up at 9:30. What's the big?
So you didn't like that? Well, I ain't doing this effing show anymore.
No. Ronnie, come back!
Ronnie. No!
Ronnie!
No!
Melissa, look what you've done! Get
Where's
Ronnie back! Get Ronnie back! I've had it! Ronnie!
No more for me!
Who needs him? I'll take over.
Don't let the door hit you on the way out.
Everyone be nice. You got to cut clothes off today. You got cake.
I was just teasing.
Clair, we got some time left. We'll probably take another break, but we got some time left. Is there anything else you want to slice in here tonight?
Yeah.
I would like to take off Joe Poo's clothes.
All right. Both the girls together can do that.
All right. Well,
a tag team.
Let's do it really quickly, Fez. We'll take a break.
All right.
And by the time we're up, we'll slice that look in his face. So
we'll have Joe Poo up on the table when we come back.
As soon as I thought I was out, they're pulling me back in.
I think it's time for C's.
Why did I do my 10 o'clock joke at 9:52? I had nothing this hour. They act like they're my radio parents, but they hate me.
All right, Joe Poo gets sliced, 877-692-1027, when we return.
It's Rod and Fez Show.
Ron and Fez, 1027 WNEW. He claims he's from a different world.
Hello, people of Earth.
He's Gay-Pax.
You're telling me you can see ultraviolet colors?
No, I'm telling you I can see that these colors don't do a thing for this room. Is this planet called Earth or Drabsville?
Gay-Pax. He can communicate with other life forms.
Your dog says he doesn't like it when you sneak up on him from behind. I know the feeling. Ouch! But he does like that trick you do with the peanut butter. Yummy!
No way!
Gay-Pax, you won't believe an alien this gay is real.
Your produce alone has been worth the trip.
Hey, what are you doing with that banana? I put down that zucchini. You're disgusting.
Gay-Pax, opening soon for everybody.
All right, everyone, we're headed back to my planet for daiquiris.
Gay-Pax original soundtrack also available.
Get your balls out!
Also includes the hit Mind Games by Kevin Spacey. Available wherever gay music is sold.
We're running fast. About ready to wrap up Crazy Claire's birthday party. She wants to do a cuttin'. I guess, now Crazy Claire, is your new friend Liz going to help you cut the clothes off of Joe Poo?
I think she is.
I would love to.
Let's do it.
Joe, how do you feel about this?
Playing tag team.
Oh, it's great.
He looks very excited.
He looks as excited as Al was.
Al almost passed out.
All right, now we only have, 12 minutes, Fez?
Yeah, under that, actually.
Oh, wow. We're going to miss Sears? Don't worry about the Sears.
The Sears will take care of themselves.
He's so worried about it now.
Sure. All right, go ahead and lay down for the girls.
Just the pants, all right?
Just the pants.
just a little.
So nice. It's like a haircut. Just a little off the top, please.
Does he have other pants to wear home?
What are you doing with your hand?
I'm covering them up.
I know.
You're covering up your nads. Part of the fun is you might get your nads cut off.
Hey, that's right. Not fun for me.
Now he's covering up the hole, so nothing.
Yeah. Hey. Okay, go ahead, girls.
Yeah. No, I just thought I got to get home.
Where did that voice come from?
What the hell?
I got nothing else to go home in.
You're stabbing.
I got nowhere else to go.
Are we stabbing you?
How's it feel? Can you?
Oh, this is erotic.
Here's the thing. These big thick sweatpants. How is it feeling anything?
Swear to God, you miss. I'll punch you right in the forehead.
Joe,
what?
Get your hands off your nads. That's your fun.
Yeah.
Your nads are out. The idea of this, the eroticism behind it, is to trust the other person
I'm
with the knife.
Oh, get
your
right.
I'm afraid we're going to find more fungus.
You leave my fruit out of this.
You leave it out of the loom.
Would you please take your hand off your balls? That's half the fun. The trust.
Now he's got his hand over them, not on them.
I need these to reproduce.
They're covering.
We don't need any more poos.
Now we're all
packaged. You do. You do not. The absolute dinginess of those underwear on a night that you know you were getting your pants cut.
You
off.
Knew this was going to happen.
This was the cleanest pair.
You wore the grayest, yellowest drawers ever.
They are battleship gray.
Oh.
Where's the shark teeth on them?
Make sure he feels that knife a little bit so he knows you mean business.
Yeah. Shave off some of that thigh hair. All right, I'm getting an innie from this. Let me put it this way in radio terms. The businessman has just picked up the luggage and went in the tunnel.
That's radio terms. I had no idea that was radio terms.
It's on the memo.
What? Liz, you want a knife?
Tell me
you want to help?
Looks when like your mom got you shin. Those underwear, who was president? Tell me the truth.
Reagan.
That was a Carter years if it was a decade.
Look at this pale skin. The skin is as gray as the underwear.
I know. What happened to your kneecaps? You're coming back like a four-year-old boy all banged up on your knees.
Looks like someone kicked him in the shins, right?
I played a lot of years of hockey.
Permanent bruises.
Claire, just, I hope
oh,
that, I
my
hope,
God, I can't believe these underwear.
I hope the
you
smell...
You know what was happening tonight.
I got nice
legs.
Feet.
I got nice legs, don't I? Well, I'm sure they move and they carry your body.
Right.
But other than that, they got nothing going for them.
Right now, they're carrying the ugliest pair of underwear I've ever seen in my life.
PT-109 was that color. That's how gray they are. They're battleship gray.
He bought them the same year.
Oh, he's breathing hard, Fuzzy. He's turned on.
You want me
how
to
about
know
right
him?
There?
I'll get... What happened, Joe?
Get him as close as you can to the boys. Get that sharp knife.
Joe, you're going to get your thumb cut.
I'd rather my thumb get cut off. Get him as close...
Same size.
I feel like in third grade and the child toucher walked in the broom closet with me. Now, tell
how'd
him,
you get him to go in the broom
right
closet
there,
with
Joe?
You?
Hey, you're stabbing for real.
Hey, is it
51
hey.
Minutes of the hour yet?
No, we got plenty of time.
There we go, Joe. You like that?
I just finished the...
He
swallowed his
gum.
He just swallowed his juicy fruit.
Just finished the pants. This bit and pants is fine.
No, it's just...
No, this is too much fun.
Also, it would be sexy to slice off his shoelaces.
Right, and those bright orange
bright
things.
Orange.
I just bought them.
They glow.
Well, why don't you save your money on shoelaces and pick up a pair of underwear?
You know what? The shoelaces should never be the cleanest thing you're wearing.
I'll agree with you on that.
That should never happen.
He needs a donation, like someone donates some underwear.
How about $2?
I bet you could buy a nice pair of underwear for $2.
You are so sick with the color of those.
I can't believe the dullness.
The underwear or the laces?
Is there any bleach in that house of yours?
The shoelaces are as bright as Lucy's hair. And the underwear is what Lucy's skin looks like now.
And they do not go well with gray undies. What's wrong, Joe? You're wincing.
I'm scared.
Are you feeling the knife?
Yeah, because she's a crazy woman over there.
Melissa's holding her holding his head up for him. Melissa, I haven't heard you do your sexy talk for this one.
This isn't very sexy.
Oh, thanks a lot.
This is the worst thing since Melissa did the body shot off that guy who owns Java and came up with a mouthful of fur.
Did you just cut his socks?
Yeah.
She's holding my head like I'm a Vietnam vet and she's giving me my last rites.
This is cute.
Look at him with his hands on his little peach.
Take the hand away and let the girls work.
Oh, I don't think so.
It's like he's in a soccer game and he's protecting the goal.
He's worried about a surprise jock inspection right now.
Now, Liz, come on over. Tell me the truth. Look at his M. Is this why guys turn you off?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen...
Oh, poor Joe.
Hey, I didn't say nothing about you, right?
She looked fantastic.
All right, Joe, you're hanging out your slot.
By the way, we just found out your thighs are a size 34.
Hey, I have running back legs. That's what my mother told me.
So that is shame.
While your legs were wrapped around.
Who said this to you? Who said this to you? Grishiki Poo? Your mom?
I think it was Red Grange.
Now, are we doing the shirt, ladies, or not?
No.
No, he needs the shirt.
I need the shirt.
All right, because he's got to go home.
Well, you got two shirts.
No, I need both of them. And I need my skin and my heart and all the organs surrounding it.
There's only one organ you seem to be concerned with, Dingy Drawers.
Yeah, I can live without a heart.
How about right there, Joe? Does that feel good? Like right on the inner thigh?
Yes, does anything feel good for you, Joe?
Yeah, but we can't say that on the air.
If anything, you're scratching his jock itch for him.
I bet he has more fungus.
It's his plant is nuts.
He's hiding the fungus.
You know, if his feet look like that, God knows what it looks like under his sack. The moss that's growing down there.
Yeah, it looks like a turtle trying to escape from the rainforest.
Right on the inside of your thigh.
What?
Joe, right there.
Oh, yeah, this is turning me on. Why don't you point a gun at my head?
You know, we could say go ahead and cut the underwear off, but I think they're ready to disintegrate as it is.
It was. And plus, Fez, we found that the skin is growing around them.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Worst picture ever painted. Oh, God.
All right, Joe, you can get up.
No, I'm not done with him.
Thank you, Uncle
Ron. Well, let him. I have to let him roll
over.
Joe,
Joe, you only need one. Right?
Yeah, roll over, Joe.
Roll over.
You can sell children
that
with
way,
one, right?
That way, your package will be protected.
Oh my God!
Oh, the stains,
Fezzi. It looks like the flag of Portugal back there.
All right, guess who had bacon strips for breakfast? Oh, you're so disgusting!
Joe, you could have worn boxers. Do you own boxers? All right, you know what, Joe? Here.
He's got skins!
Oh. You don't have a skin mark. My gosh, you've got a skin parking lot there.
It looks like high school kids have been peeling out on your pants. It's the runway of the Newark Airport.
Someone did a donut in your yard. Oh, my gosh, I've never seen such filthy underwear. Joe, you laid on your own mic button. What'd you say? Quit turning off your own mic or the shorts are going.
Sorry, it's my breasts. I'm a sex icon for the blind.
Hey, the blind can still smell you, filthy bastard. Oh.
They can feel the texture of the fungus as well.
Does anyone remember how turned on we were when the girls were slicing each other?
It's hard to at this point.
How prepared they were. And then you come in there with those...
Yeah, I feel like we
dingy
know.
Shorts.
I covered them up.
Filled with bacon strips.
Claire, I know you're keeping the Liz's top. as a souvenir tonight.
Okay.
Did you want to keep the shorts, too?
Well, for kindling, maybe.
I would not put an open match around them.
That's the flag of Bayonne, sister. Fly it high.
Joe.
Dirty fruit of the loom.
Joseph Poo.
Hello.
Bayonne, how we love you. Bayonne.
You knew you were coming in here tonight and meeting Crazy Claire, and she may cut your clothes off.
This was, I actually searched through the laundry bag. This was the cleanest pair.
And those are his sister's underwear.
Oh, God.
Colleen's
no
gone.
No wonder they're loose on him.
Colleen's gone. Now I can't go out tonight. He's got the family drawers.
Wait a minute. Let me check the schedule. Is it your night for the underwear? Damn. Oh, boy. Look where the time went.
That was fun. Paranoid showed up, Fezzy, but we don't have his camera yet. Paranoid. Mm.
Can I get down from here?
Bring Paranoid
now,
in.
Stay exactly where you are.
Stay put for just 2 seconds till we get out of the place.
Paranoid, we will get that camera for you. But did you get the secret message from tonight's show?
I got your subliminal message, and I appreciate it, man. This is an amazing night. I can't believe it. Joe.
Did you see Joe's ass?
I think I'm stalking somebody.
Oh, hold on. You want to see the whole ass?
Oh!
What are you doing, Paranoid?
I think I love you. Let me say this. New song coming.
I will say this. Your gross ass looks better than your underwear.
Yeah, that's pretty nasty, but I still love you, Joe.
Hey, thanks, Bex.
Can we cover it up again, please?
Yeah.
Golly.
Come on. All right.
All right, I'm getting down.
Let's go Joe's
short.
Let's do the Sears, Alex, Pooter Toot, Chris, and Kimmy. Fezzy, we do have to get going.
Yes, we do. We're actually late now.
So. Hey, Rich, Patrick, Big Jim, and Anthony, quick Sears. Thanks so much for Liz. Happy birthday, Claire.
Happy birthday, Claire.
Thank you, sweet Melissa.
Sweet Melissa. Woo.
Thank you for letting me cut people's clothes off.
Always. Paranoid, thank you, buddy. I hope you got the messages.
Thank you, Joe Poo. And thanks again to our pals at JetBlue.
Now we know where he got his name from, Joe Poo.
Gross. JetBlue. It's not the only way to fly, but it should be.
His full name is Joe Poo Pants.
We're Ron and Fez. We'll be back tomorrow at 7, right after Opie and Anthony.
Ron and Fez.
107. WNEW. Ronnie, Joe Poo's trying to get out of the studio. Look at the droopy drawers. He's leaving in his underwear, and they are just hanging down below his knees.
He's taking the walk of shame.
He's in combat boots and underwear that are just drooping. There's no elastic left.
My hand to God, these are the clean ones.
All right, here we go. Talking about double D's. Double the entertainment of just the average gentleman's club.
Double the entertainment, Fezzy. Double your fun at Double D's. Located in Morristown, New Jersey, Double D's is the eighth wonder of the gentleman's entertainment world.
They have 2 Double D rooms, a New York-style club with runway stage, club seating, and VIP champagne lounge.
Or you got that Jersey-style club, 20-foot-high ceilings, state-of-the-art sound and lighting system.
And, of course, the Double D's, from steaks to crab cakes, the food is as tasty as the women.
Double D's, that's the bachelor party capital with their own private limousine service. Give them a call, 973-326-9554, 973-326-9554.
You can check out Double D's for yourself online at DoubleD's-Morristown.com. That's DoubleD's-Morristown.com.
Located in Morristown, New Jersey, right off of Route 287, minutes from Routes 80, 24, and 280, it's Double D's, the eighth wonder of the men's entertainment world.